Witt throws the basketball away.
Good pass.
Pass to Autumn Ross, lays it up and in. Good assist. Witt throws the basketball away.
Good pass.
Pass to Autumn Ross, lays it up and in. Good assist by Ashton Ferguson.
And Murray wants the ball. He's got it going to his left.
Got some pressure, and he's down. What a...
Dark horse for the 14th region in preseason, so we'll see what happens today.
My name is Zach Engel, and I'm the branch manager here at First National Bank in West Liberty. Everyone here is excited to cheer on the Morgan County football team and its cheerleaders this upcoming season. Go Cougars!
First National Bank is committed to providing quality services to our customers. First National Bank offers a wide variety of account options. When you need a loan, First National Bank offers an assortment of loan options. We are excited to offer our home equity line of credit loans with zero closing costs. Stop by today and ask one of our knowledgeable team members for more information on our banking products.
Caney Valley Propane, located near West Liberty, is here to take care of all your propane needs. We offer tank fill-ups for home or business. Stop by our office and we can fill up your cylinders too. Need an upgrade or don't have a propane system? We can set you up with a new efficient system for your home or business. We also sell and service wall heaters, fireplaces, and gas logs. So don't get left in the cold. Call Caney Valley Propane.
Life is filled with moments, some monumental, some mere seconds. Moments we often take for granted as we worry and anticipate all the moments to come. At Woodman Life, we help ease that worry with our affordable insurance and retirement products. We work to protect financial security, community pride, patriotism, and peace of mind so that you can protect the moments that matter most.
Gentlemen, at this time, please turn your attention to the field as we honor these young men and women tonight for Senior Night. They have given so much to Morgan County over the years, and this night is theirs. First, we'd like to welcome Senior Shelby Brown.
I've been on this team for 6 years now.
Ever since I was little, I wanted to be a cheerleader. Cheer has always been a big part of my life. I was asked to be on the high school cheer team in just seventh grade. My best memory from... My name is Shelby Brown. I am being escorted tonight by my brother Caleb Brown, my dad John Brown, and my mom and stepdad Tracy and Terry Wireman. I have been on this team for 6 years now. Ever since I was little, I wanted to be a cheerleader. Cheer has always been a big part of my life. I was asked to be on the high school cheer team in just seventh grade. My best memory from cheer is when we won districts my seventh grade year. After high school, I plan on attending Ashland Community and Technical College with plans of becoming a cosmetologist. I would like to thank my mom and dad for always supporting me and coming to all of my games. I also want to thank all of my coaches, especially Amber Standifer and Tabby Conley, for pushing me to work hard and help me accomplish all of my goals. I would like to thank my team for working hard and to be the best that we can. I want to say a special thanks to my best friend Kylie for doing everything with me. I've always been so excited for my senior year. If you ask my grandma, she'll tell you it's because I love bossing people around. Though she may be right about that, it's not the whole reason I've been excited for this year. I would like to thank my grandma for always bringing me to and from practices and games. She has always been there for me. Lastly, I would like to remind all of my girls to slay every day. Love y'all. Shelby out. Go Cougars.
Ladies and gentlemen, Shelby Brown. Next, we'd like to welcome senior Casey Montgomery.
Hi, my name is Casey Montgomery, and I'm the daughter of Missy Hoskins and the late Adam Montgomery. Tonight, I'm being escorted out by my mom, Missy Hoskins, my stepdad, Corey Hoskins, and my three siblings, Preston, Carson, and Tori Hoskins. This is my fourth year on the cheer team, and I've greatly enjoyed it. My favorite memory is competing in districts last year and placing second. It might not have been the outcome that we hoped for, but we came a very long way and never gave up. After high school, I plan on attending Morehead State University and majoring in early elementary education in hopes of becoming a kindergarten teacher. I would like to thank my mom and Corey for always being very supportive and coming to all my games, and to my coaches, Tabby and Shelley, for always pushing for me to do my best. I'm very thankful for all the memories, lessons, and friendships I've gained from cheer throughout these 4 years. Thank you for everything. Go Cougars!
Ladies and gentlemen, Casey Montgomery. Next, we'd like to welcome senior Brooklyn Ramey.
Hi, I'm Brooklyn Ramey. I'm being escorted tonight by my parents, Lakin and Gary Ramey, and my siblings, Natalie, Maverick, and Everly Ramey. I have been a part of this varsity team for 4 years, but have cheered since I was in kindergarten. I always look forward to being like the older girls on the high school team. I grew up watching cheer videos all over YouTube thinking about how cool being in a pyramid would be, but I never dreamed it would come and go this fast. After graduation, I plan to attend Morehead State University and further my education as either high school, agriculture, or English teacher. My favorite memory through cheer has been all the best rides with my best friend and best buddy since freshman year, Casey Montgomery. This opportunity has made us so much closer, and I will forever be grateful for that. I'm glad cheer brought me so many girls I consider close friends now. I want to thank my coaches for always pushing me to do what I don't think I'm capable of, my dad for working his hardest to get me where I need to be, my mom for being my biggest supporter, and my friends for continuing to always be there for me. Although my journey is slowly coming to an end, cheering for the Cougars will always have a special place in my heart. Once a Cougar, always a Cougar.
Ladies and gentlemen, Brooklyn Ramey. Let's welcome Jace Adkins.
My name is Jace Atkins. Tonight I'm being escorted by my mom, Joni Atkins, my sister, Lindsay Atkins, and my grandparents, Linda and Vonda Atkins. After school, I plan on becoming a lineman. The person I look up to the most is my dad, who unfortunately couldn't make it tonight due to work. This makes my second year on this team. I'd like to thank all the coaches for making me a better version of myself. But I've got to give a big thanks to the main man, Don McKenzie, for everything he's done for this community. We love you, Don. It's been a good run, boys, but this is 5, signing off.
Ladies and gentlemen, Jace Atkins. Let's welcome senior Ryan Collinsworth.
Hello, my name is Ryan Collinsworth. I'm being escorted by my mom, Heather, and my dad, Rusty. I've been a part of the Morgan County football team for 2 years. I plan on attending Eastern Kentucky University to pursue a career in culinary arts. For all the underclassmen, make every minute on this field count and stick with it even when things aren't going your way. Thank you to the coaches for coaching their hearts out for us and for the life lessons I'll carry with me forever. It's been a privilege to be a part of this program as short as my time was. 22, signing off.
Ladies and gentlemen, Ryan Collinsworth. Welcome senior Drake Linden.
My name is Drake Linden. Tonight, I'm being escorted by my mom, Amy Linden, dad, Noel Linden, and brother, Walker Crace. After school, I plan on attending Maysville Technical College and pursuing a degree in mechanical coding. I've been a part of this team for 3 years, and I want to appreciate all the coaches for putting in the hard work and effort to make my time here fun. I want to thank my team and everyone who supports the Morgan County Cougars. This is 52, signing out.
Ladies and gentlemen, Drake Linden. Welcome, senior Joe Spencer.
Hi, my name is Joe Spencer. Tonight I'm being escorted by my mom, Rebecca Spencer, my dad, Frankie Spencer, my sister, Gracie Spencer, and my godfather, Polo Easton. I have played football for 3 years and been on this team for 3 years. I'd like to thank all my coaches for always making me better. My favorite memory on the team was when we beat Knott Central in last year's Sorting Bowl. It's been fun. Number 20, out.
Ladies and gentlemen, Joe Spencer. Welcome, senior Riley Standifer.
Hey, my name is Riley Standifer. I'm being escorted tonight by my mom, Tammy Standifer, my dad, John Standifer, my papa, Tom Standifer, and my little sister, Bailey Standifer. I have played football for 14 years and been on this team for 4. My favorite memory from football is when we won the Sorghum Bowl last year. After high school, I plan on working with my dad, John, and my uncle, Jeff, at Standifer Builders. I'd like to thank my mom and dad for always supporting me and helping me any way they could. I would also like to thank my coaches for always pushing me to work hard. Lastly, big thanks to Donnie McKenzie for everything he has done for our program. Donnie asked me when I first started playing to keep this number until I graduated. Donnie, the time has come. Number 4 out. Go Cougars.
Ladies and gentlemen, Riley Standifer. Let's give our seniors another round of applause.
The Citizens Bank is a locally owned bank that offers totally free checking for everyone. No hoops, no hassle. With our totally free checking, enjoy banking on the go with mobile banking, mobile deposit, bill pay, and the ability to send money to friends, family, and coworkers instantly with Zelle for free. Call or stop by today at one of our 5 banking centers for more information. The Citizens Bank, member FDIC.
For nearly 50 years, Bank of the Mountains has served Morgan and the surrounding counties, working hard to provide our customers with friendly service and the financial products that make their lives easier. As a family-owned bank, we understand that relationships matter. We appreciate those who have chosen us to be their bank and invite those who haven't to stop by at any of our 3 locations, West Liberty, Index, or Ezel. Local people, local decisions, local commitment. Bank of the Mountains is proud to be a real community bank. Member FDIC. Equal housing lender.
I'm Kevin Anderson, and I want to take this time to tell you the difference between my opponent and I. My opponent voted against a $106 million expansion of the Little Sandy Correctional Facility in Sandy Hook that costed Elliott County $1 million in payroll tax and 150 permanent jobs. He also voted against a $75 million Agritech Research and Development Center in Round County and $50 million in road projects. I will always vote for the betterment of the 99th District. Please vote for me, Kevin Anderson, on November 8th.
Are you tired of the same old cell phone? Want a new phone, but really don't want to pay the hundreds of dollars up front for it? Appalachian Wireless has a deal for you. Get the phone you actually want instead of settling for a cheaper phone with the Appalachian Advantage Plan. Instead of paying $600 or more for the best phone, simply pay the taxes up front and then a few bucks a month more on your monthly bill. Stop by your local Appalachian Wireless store or dealer today for more information. It's the better, simpler way to pay. And it's called the Appalachian Advantage because we are you. We are Appalachian Wireless.
Hi, I'm Brock Littrell, President of Commercial Bank of West Liberty. For more than 100 years, we've prided ourselves on treating our customers like family. The technologies we offer afford you the ability to bank with us from anywhere.
Hi, I'm Angie Pendergrass. I'm the CFO of Commercial Bank, and we are constantly looking for new technologies to improve our efficiencies and our bottom line. But more importantly, it allows us to spend more time with our customers.
Hi, I'm Howard Elam, CEO of Commercial Bank. I'd like to thank you for trusting us with your banking needs.
Welcome to Morgan County High School in Don McKenzie Field. I'm Chris Dickerson along with Stephen Gullett and the rest of the MTTV Sports Television crew welcoming you to this final Friday night football telecast of the high school football season between the Morgan County Cougars and the Magoffin County Hornets. Steve, first thing I want to say tonight is welcome back. I missed you here 2 weeks ago against Breathitt County, and I'm glad you're back with us tonight.
Yeah, good to be back, and it is fall. It is already dark, and it gets dark quick this time of year. But we're ready for some football tonight.
A beautiful fall evening here in West Liberty, 57 degrees under clear skies and calm winds, just absolutely perfect for this final game of the regular season for Morgan County, and it's also senior night here tonight for the Morgan County Cougars. This football telecast, Morgan County Cougars football, being brought to you by Appalachian Wireless, Bank of the Mountains, Caney Valley Propane, Commercial Bank, Dave Eisen, candidate for Morgan County Judge Executive, First National Bank, Frederick Law Office, PLLC, Stanifer Builders, Vicki Oldfield, Realtor for Homeland Real Estate, the Citizens Bank, G&S Concrete and Metal Roofing Services, Woodman Life, Tony Smith, candidate for West Liberty City Council, Jim Gazay, candidate for Morgan County Judge Executive, and Kevin Anderson, candidate for representative of the 99th District. We'll go back to the studio for a few commercials, and we'll be back to get you ready for the battle between the Hornets and the Cougars right here on the Morgan County Cougars Football Network.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we and the rocket's red
The Citizens Bank is a locally owned bank that offers totally free checking for everyone. No hoops, no hassle. With our totally free checking, enjoy banking on the go with mobile banking, mobile deposit, bill pay, and the ability to send money to friends, family, and coworkers instantly with Zelle for free. Call or stop by today at one of our five banking centers for more information. The Citizens Bank, member FDIC.
Standifer Builders is the area's best general contracting and paving company, serving you since 1965. We're family-owned and operated, and we're ready to meet your needs. Our friendly and experienced staff has the expertise to do the job right, no matter the size. We offer residential and commercial paving without the hassle of a big contractor. Call us today to schedule your free estimate. Standifer Builders is a proud supporter of local high school sports. Good luck to all athletes this season.
We're under 4.5 minutes away from kickoff between the Morgan County Cougars and the Magoffin County Hornets. It is senior night here at Don McKenzie Field, and the seniors for Morgan County, both cheerleaders and football players, were introduced here before the game. You saw that here on our broadcast. Cheerleaders were Shelby Brown, Casey Montgomery, and Brooklyn Ramey. And your five senior football players that were announced before the game were number 5, Jace Atkins, 5'11", senior. He plays running back, wide receiver, and defensive back. Number 22, Ryan Collinsworth, 5'10 and a half, senior, plays both sides of the football, wide receiver and linebacker on defense. Number 52, Drake Linden, 5'8", senior, plays both sides of the ball on the line, the offensive line and defensive line. Number 20, Joe Spencer, a 6-foot senior, wide receiver and plays linebacker on the defensive side of the ball. And the final senior of the night that was announced was number 4, Riley Stanifer. Stanifer, a 5'9 senior, played wide receiver, running back, and defensive back on the defensive side of the football. And we want to wish all of these kids well, Steve, on their senior night and their final game of their high school career. A big night for these kids.
Yeah, special night. It's always a special night when seniors, you know, on senior night. And it's hard to say goodbye, and it's a sad night. It's, you know, it's kind of a little bit, you know, both ways there. But they've had good careers, and we wish them the best. And it's hard to believe that those kids are seniors. I know just about every one of them. It's kind of like this season is almost coming to an end, and time just keeps going faster and faster, seems like.
It keeps going faster and faster. It just seems like a couple of weeks ago that the season was starting over here, and now here it is, the final game of the regular season. These two teams have a pretty heated rivalry between them in football. They last met last year on October the 29th. Magoffin County won that football game in Sagersville 28-26. They did not play in 2020 because of COVID. In 2019, at Sagersville, Magoffin County defeated Morgan County 48-22. And in 2018, that's the last time these two teams met here in West Liberty. Morgan County won that game over Magoffin County 34-24, and that was in the Sorghum Bowl on September the 28th. So usually when these teams get together, Steve, they put a lot of points on the scoreboard. I know Morgan County has a lot of injuries and kids that's not on the field now that started the season. I understand Magoffin County's down to their third-string quarterback starting this game here tonight, so a lot of kids are going to get a lot of action that at the first of the year they probably didn't think they'd get to see.
Yeah, so a lot of what-ifs in this game tonight, and we'll see what happens, and, you know, we'll see who steps up, and good opportunities sometimes for these kids, these young kids, to kind of show what they can do and get some experience under the belt, and so we'll see which team steps up and gets ready to play.
Morgan County comes into this game with a record of 1-8, and they also come in off of a bye. 2 weeks ago here on Friday night was their last game, and Breathitt County defeated Morgan County in that game. Morgan County was off last week. They close out the regular season here tonight against Magoffin County, and next Friday evening the Kentucky State High School playoffs will get underway for football, and Morgan County will travel to Pike County to take on Shelby Valley in the opening round of the Class 2A playoffs in the state of Kentucky. Magoffin County, a Class 3A school in football, the Hornets with a record of 3-6 coming into this game tonight. This is also their final regular season game, and they will open up playoff action next week as they travel to Putnam Stadium in Iceland and will take on the Iceland Paul Blazer Tomcats. So a tough assignment for both of these teams next week on the road in the playoffs. But for tonight, it's Magoffin County and Morgan County getting ready to tee it up, and Magoffin County will kick this football off to start this game as Morgan County comes out to line up to get ready to receive the ball, and we're just about ready for football here at Don McKenzie Field.
And football is a little bit different than any other sport. Seems like every game is a playoff game, and you got to win every one of them, and it is tough. And if you don't win those games, you're going to play somebody tough in that first round of that turn in the playoffs.
Ben Lafferty will tee it up for the Hornets on the 40-yard line. Morgan County with a pair of receivers deep back on their own 20, and we're just about ready to go. Let's play football here at Don McKenzie Field. Wherever you may be across our viewing area, welcome to Morgan County Cougars football. Noah Lewis picks that football up on his own 30-yard line and returns it to the 34, and that'll be where the Cougars will take over with their first possession of the evening.
And again, this field is a beautiful field. It's named after a great guy, wonderful fella, Donnie McKenzie. And under lights, it's just more beautiful, I think. And we're going to start this game under the lights, and we'll play it the whole time under the lights.
We've been to a couple of different stadiums and done games here this year on MTTV. I went to Fairview when we wasn't showing it just to watch them, and this is by far the most beautiful stadium of any field of any that we've played in for high school facilities. It's great.
It sure is.
First and 10 for the Cougars. First play from scrimmage of the evening. And a handoff and out over the 35 to about the 39-yard line goes Chance Wright.
Yeah, I got some positive yardage there. So good carry.
So a gain of 5 yards on the carry. And that'll bring up second down and 5 now for the Cougars. Just underway here at Don McKenzie Field. Nickel hands off and up to the 40-yard line. Goes Chance Wright. So he picks up 1 yard on the play. And that'll bring up third down and 4 for Morgan County. First third down of the evening. Morgan County has gotten off to slow starts in a lot of these games this year, Steve. The one game they did not was at Jackson County, the game we done, and they shut Jackson County out and won that football game.
Yeah, they started off hot and they finished hot, and they played really hard, and it was a great game for the Cougars. We'll see what happens here.
Nickel hands that football off again to Chance Wright, and he stopped for no gain. They mark it right on the 40-yard line, so that'll bring up 4th and 4 for the Cougars.
How about you, fans? Let's hear you.
Yeah, I think Coach Eichling was actually thinking about going for that, but had second thoughts, and looks like they are going to punt it.
So Rogers will come in to punt this football away for Morgan County. Magoffin County's defense goes 3 and out against Morgan County here in the first possession. Rogers, a good booming high kick. Receiver takes the football on the 33, and he's tackled right there. So a good kick.
Yeah, that was definitely one of the best kicks I've seen from Morgan County this year, and got some height and had some hang time, didn't it?
They'll mark that football on the 34-yard line, it looks like. So first and 10 for Magoffin County, their first possession of the evening at the 9:52 mark of the first period. Handoff goes to McCarty. He turns the corner. A big gainer for the Hornets all the way down into Morgan County territory, and he's finally run out of bounds.
Big kid
down inside the 35-yard line. So Ian McCarty turned the corner, Steve, and he was gone.
He sure was. Got some good blocks. And
33-yard run flips the end of the field. And a good start for the Hornets. They have the football first and 10 now on the Morgan County 33-yard line.
And that's kind of been the Achilles for the Cougars. Seems like they give up some big plays.
Curtis Jenkins, the ball carrier for the Hornets. And they mark that football on the 29-yard line, so that's a gain of four. It'll bring up second down and six for the Hornets. And, Steve, you're correct. That's been the Achilles heel of this defense for Morgan County this year is on the ground. Their ground defense, they've given up some huge plays.
Yep, they'll play tough for a couple plays, and all of a sudden they just give up one big one. And, you know.
So the back in motion takes the handoff, comes around the near side, turns the corner, gets it down inside the 20-yard line. And that was Ben Lafferty. Lafferty moves the chains for Magoffin County, and it'll be first and 10 for the Hornets on the 20-yard line. So a 9-yard gain for Lafferty.
So we'll see if the defense of the Cougars can settle down here and get a stop.
McCarty down inside the 20, the 10, the 5, and he takes it into the end zone for the touchdown. So McCarty puts the first score of the ball game on the boards. And it's a touchdown for the Hornets, and Magoffin County takes a 6-0 lead at the 8:51 mark of the first period. So the Hornets will line up to go for two. Running back on each side of the quarterback and then another behind. Handoff goes to Lafferty. He sweeps it around the right, and he's tripped up by Cameron Rogers. He makes a good play in the backfield to tackle Lafferty. So the two-point conversion's no good. And at the 8:51 mark left of the first period, your score at Don McKenzie Field, Magoffin County 6, Morgan County nothing. You're watching Morgan County football on the Morgan County Cougars Football Network.
I'm Kevin Anderson. I'm running for state representative in the 99th District. I am for the working people in our area. My opponent voted to cut unemployment from 20 weeks to 12 weeks. He was the only legislator, Republican or Democrat, in Eastern Kentucky to cast that vote. I will always stand with the working class people of the 99th District. I humbly ask for your vote on November 8th.
My name is Zach Engel, and I'm the branch manager here at First National Bank in West Liberty. Everyone here is excited to cheer on the Morgan County football team and its cheerleaders this upcoming season. Go Cougars!
First National Bank is committed to providing quality services to our customers. First National Bank offers a wide variety of account options. When you need a loan, First National Bank offers an assortment of loan options. We are excited to offer our home equity line of credit loans with zero closing costs. Stop by today and ask one of our knowledgeable team members for more information on our banking products.
He kicks the football away for the Hornets. And out across the 35, turns the corner and going out of bounds at the 40 was Bradley Nickel.
Just couldn't turn the corner quick enough there. He had to got pushed back and pushed over and run out of real estate.
So Morgan County will begin their second drive of the evening on the 41-yard line. And the Cougars trail Magoffin County 6-0 here in the first period at West Liberty. Steve, their first drive was 3-and-out. They need to see if they can get something going here the second time they have the football.
And that first drive, they ran the ball on three plays, and let's see if they continue to do that or maybe look to.
Again, they hand the football off, and a good run this time across the 50-yard line and into Magoffin County territory goes Chance Wright.
And I believe that's enough for a first down, looks like.
It is a 10-yard run.
Face mask against the Hornets.
So that's a 10-yard run and a first down, and then a face mask penalty will advance it another 5 yards. Good run by the Cougars there. So we'll see if we can't get that going again.
Handoff goes to right, another big hole down inside the 35, down to the 32-yard line, so a gain of 12 there.
And that'll be enough for a first down, Cougars!
So the Cougars are having some success running up the right up the middle. So
chance right with a good run there of 12 yards, 13 yards make it as they mark it on the 31. And it's first and 10 for the Cougars from that point. So this rivalry has had a lot of points in the past, and both teams are off to a fast start here this evening. Morgan County trying to answer the Magoffin County score. Nickel hands it off to Wright again. Why not? He goes around the left down inside the 30 to the 20. And they'll mark Chance at the 19-yard line. That's a 12-yard gain. And another first down.
So that's three first downs on this drive.
Three first downs on three runs.
Looks like a completely different team that was on that first drive.
It certainly does. They marked that football on the 18-yard line. So that was a 12-yard gain for Wright. And the clock approaches 7 minutes left here in the first period. And Morgan County has the football in the Magoffin County red zone. Their first trip to the red zone here this evening on their second possession. Two receivers here to the near side. Nickel takes the low snap. Rolls near side, looks in the corner of the end zone, and that pass is caught for the touchdown. Beautiful pass from Nickel to Joe Spencer. And Spencer with a great over-the-shoulder catch.
Yeah, a beautiful play. Good throw, great catch, right in stride there in the corner.
So Spencer with a beautiful catch in the right corner of the end zone, over the shoulder catch, good pass by Nickel. He put it right where it had to be, and Morgan County quickly answers the Magoffin County score, and we're tied at 6. So Morgan County will line up for the two-point conversion as Nickel brings the play in from the sideline for the Cougars. Two receivers here to the near side. Nickel hands it off to Rogers, and Rogers spins and he stopped. So the two-point conversion fails, and our score here at the 6:43 mark of the first period, Morgan County 6, Magoffin County 6, and we'll be back to Don McKenzie Field right after this.
The Citizens Bank is a locally owned bank that offers totally free checking for everyone. No hoops, no hassle. With our totally free checking, enjoy banking on the go with mobile banking, mobile deposit, bill pay, and the ability to send money to friends, family, and coworkers instantly with Zelle for free. Call or stop by today at one of our 5 banking centers for more information. The Citizens Bank, member FDIC.
So Morgan County answers the Magoffin County score. It's 6-6 here. As Braxton Sexton lines up to kick this ball away for Morgan County. And the squib kick is mishandled and now picked up on the 20-yard line. and Garrett Jenkins is tackled on the 25-yard line.
We talk about how important momentum is in sports, and I tell you what, it can change in a heartbeat, and right now I think the Cougars got a little bit of momentum here, so let's see if they can get that momentum on the defensive side here.
A good answer by the Cougars offense to that first Magoffin County drive to tie this game up. Now let's see if we can play some defense here and get this football back. First and 10 for the Hornets. Back on each side of the quarterback. Burchett hands it off to Lafferty. He turns the corner, crosses out over the 30-yard line, and Lafferty will step out of bounds on the 31-yard line.
And once again, a good crowd here at the Don McKenzie Field, as usual.
A gain of 7 as they mark that on the 32, and it'll bring up 2nd and 3. Yes, a good crowd here for senior night.
Yep.
Just a beautiful evening for football. And before they can snap the football back to Burchett, the flag is thrown, and it's a dead ball, false start. On Magoffin County, so that'll back the football up to the 27-yard line after they mark off that 5-yard penalty. And that'll make it 2nd and 8. Burchett turns the corner and a big run for the Hornet quarterback. He steps out of bounds. They'll mark him, it looks like, at the past the 35-yard line. It'll be a first down, but there's a flag on the play. Let's see what this is about.
It looks like they're going backwards.
So Burchett ran that ball to the 36-yard line and had a first down.
But
then a holding penalty will back that run up all the way back to the 25-yard line. So that winds up being an 11-yard penalty. It cost them 11 yards, Steve, and that's a big penalty there.
That is big. So that's 2 back-to-back penalties there against the Hornets.
2nd and 10 now, and flags fly everywhere as the ball snapped this time. And I believe we had an illegal motion, and that's what it is. So that'll back it up 5 more yards.
So I think Coach Easterling is actually thinking about declining this to get it loss of down here.
And he did decline it. So the football, they give him a 2-yard gain to the 27. I don't know how they done that. They missed the spot. And the third down pass is caught. Wide open is the Hornets receiver, and here he goes down into Morgan County territory. So Burchett completed that pass to Stanifer, and he goes all the way down to the 27-yard line of Morgan County.
And again, there's that
a 50. That was a 46-yard play.
That's again, there's that big play.
Big plays, and that's been something we saw all year. Morgan County's defense will play really well.
Yep.
And then give up a big play, and that was a huge play there. Down inside the 10, and for the touchdown, the 27-yard touchdown run is Curtis Jenkins. So Jenkins turned the corner and had nothing but real estate, and he crosses the goal line, and it's a touchdown for Magoffin County. So they've touched the football twice. They've scored 2 touchdowns. And now the official, they mark the football out of bounds. So one official signaled touchdown, but now they mark it out of bounds on the 10.
Cardi on the carry. Sexton on the stop for the Cougars.
So McCarty was the ball carrier on that play. And he lost a yard. And that'll bring up second and goal now from the 11. So we have a timeout on the field. We'll take it with them. 5:08 left in the first period. Your score, Morgan County 6, Magoffin County 6, and we'll be back to Don McKenzie Field right after this.
Hi, I'm Brock Littrell, president of Commercial Bank of West
Liberty. I'm Kevin Anderson.
For more than 100 years,
we
pride ourselves on treating our customers like family. The technologies we offer afford you the ability to bank with us from anywhere.
Hi, I'm Angie Pendergrass. I'm the CFO of Commercial Bank, and we are constantly looking for new technologies to improve our efficiencies and our bottom line, but more importantly, it allows us to spend more time with our customers.
Hi, I'm Howard Elam, CEO of Commercial Bank. I'd like to thank you for trusting us with your banking needs.
McCarty turns the corner out of the timeout. He took the handoff from Burchett, and he walks it into the end zone. So an 11-yard run for Ian McCarty, and that will be a touchdown for the Hornets. So at the 4:51 mark of the second period, Magoffin County takes a 12-6 lead, and we had a flag after the touchdown. And that penalty will be assessed on the kickoff.
I started to say I did not see a flag, but evidently there was one that came out late.
So 12-6, the Hornets with the 6-point lead. They answer Morgan County's score quickly, and they'll line up to go for a 2-point conversion. Burchett in the shotgun. And Burchett keeps the football, and he'll be stopped short of the line to gain. So the 2-point conversion fails. And at the 4:51 mark of the first period, already 18 points on the board. Magoffin County 12, Morgan County 6. We'll be back to West Liberty in just a minute.
The Citizens Bank is a locally owned bank that offers totally free checking for everyone. No hoops, no hassle. With our totally free checking, enjoy banking on the go with mobile banking, mobile deposit, bill pay, and the ability to send money to friends, family, and coworkers instantly with Zelle for free. Call or stop by today at one of our 5 banking centers for more information. The Citizens Bank, member FDIC.
To 6, Magoffin County with the 6-point lead here at Don McKenzie Field. And Steve, this so far we've had a lot of points in this game here in the first 7 minutes and 9 seconds.
Yeah, and there's still plenty of time in this first quarter.
That was a short kick by Lafferty that time, taken by Noah Lewis on about the 45-yard line, and he crosses the midfield mark, and Morgan County will begin this drive on the 46-yard line.
So good field position for the Cougars on this drive.
Yes, Morgan County will start out with good field position, their best field position of the evening to start a drive. And they need to see if they can answer this second Magoffin County touchdown march. And that's exactly what it was.
Yep. Got a break in the action here. I guess would like to remind everyone out there that we are having an auction tomorrow at the Morgan County Fairgrounds. So we got about 6 vehicles to auction off. We got some office furniture to to get rid of. And 10 o'clock at the Borden County Fairgrounds tomorrow. Come out, and if you're in the market for a vehicle, we've got some good used ones.
Nickel hands the football off in a good run for Chance Wright. And he's running like a man possessed here in the first half for Morgan County. Takes that all the way down to the 32-yard line, a 14-yard gain for Wright, and a first down for Morgan County.
Yeah, he had a purpose in that run there. So, good run.
Chance Wright with five carries for 39 yards so far in this game. They give him the football again. This time he stood up by the Hornets. No gain there.
Yeah, they made him pretty much right there at the line of scrimmage.
So second down and 10 for the Cougars after the no gain. Morgan County with 47 yards rushing here in the first quarter. And they're trying to answer this last Magoffin County touchdown drive. It's 12-6, the Hornets. But the Cougars are on the move. Trip receivers to the left. Nickel in the gun. He rolls to his left. Tries to find Spencer and throws it over his head out of bounds. So that pass is incomplete.
And he really done the right thing there. If he's going to make that pass, he's got to make it. If he's going to miss, he's got to miss long.
You either
got to
hit the receiver or throw it over his head.
Exactly,
one of the two.
Yes. And so he did not leave it short.
Nickel's been out for the last couple of games with injury, so it's good to see him back in there tonight.
Yep. Kind of rolling to your left and throwing that ball there. That's a tough throw, and he got quite a bit on it.
So Nickel in the gun, he has a back to each side. Right to his left, Nickel to his right. Two receivers to the left. The handoff goes to Wright. He's down inside the 30. Quick hitter, and he's going to go inside the 10. Touchdown. 32-yard scamper and touchdown for Chance Wright. And just like that, the Cougars answer the Magoffin County touchdown with a touchdown of their own, and we're tied at 12. Steve, I'm impressed with this Morgan County offense here tonight.
They came to play, and I tell you what. And, you know, that was one thing they've had trouble with is running up the middle. And I tell you what, tonight it's working.
This offensive line's opening some holes for these running backs. And Chance Wright's had a field day here in the first quarter. Morgan County already with 79 yards on the ground here in the first period. And they'll line up to go for two.
And that one right there was a 32-yard run. So.
Wright and Nickel on each side of Blake Nickel at quarterback in the gun. He takes the snap. And he handed that off to Jacob Nickel, and the two-point conversion fails. So we've yet to see a two-point conversion that's been successful, but we've had four touchdowns here already in the first period, and as we go to break, we're tied. Morgan County 12, Magoffin County 12, and we'll be back to West Liberty right after this.
My name is Zach Engel, and I'm the branch manager here at First National Bank in West Liberty. Everyone here is excited to cheer on the Morgan County football team and its cheerleaders this upcoming season. Go Cougars!
First National Bank is committed to providing quality services to our customers. First National Bank offers a wide variety of account options. When you need a loan, First National Bank offers an assortment of loan options. We are excited to offer our home equity line of credit loans with zero closing costs. Stop by today and ask one of our knowledgeable team members for more information on our banking products.
For nearly 50 years, Bank of the Mountains has served Morgan and the surrounding counties, working hard to provide our customers with friendly service and the financial products that make their lives easier. As a family-owned bank, we understand that relationships matter. We appreciate those who have chosen us to be their bank and invite those who haven't to stop by at any of our three locations, West Liberty, Index, or Ezel. Local people, local decisions, local commitment. Bank of the Mountains is proud to be a real community bank. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Chance Wright was out for part of that Breathitt County game as he got hurt in that game last week. The week off's done him good. He's looked good. Seven touches, 71 yards, and a touchdown for Wright here in the first period as Sexton gets ready to kick this football away, and we're tied at 12. The line drive kick's taken on the 26 by Garrett Jenkins, and he goes out to about the 40-yard line. So Jenkins with a 14-yard return will make it 15 yards as they mark it at the 41. And that's where the Hornets will begin their third drive of the evening and the third drive of the first period. We've already had two possessions for each team. We've had four touchdowns on the board. And, Steve, we're not used to this. Morgan County averaging 12.4 points per game coming in to this game tonight. And they've already put 12 on the board here in the first quarter. They've looked really good.
They sure have. So if they can get a stop here on defense, get that ball back, I tell you what, they could be in control this game. And I'm sure the Hornets are thinking the same thing.
Curtis Jenkins gains five as he or six as he takes it to the 47-yard line. And that'll bring up second down and four for the Hornets. So here goes Magoffin County again. It's just back and forth, back and forth.
And let's see if the Cougars cannot avoid that big play here.
This game's turning into a game that maybe whoever can make a defensive stop will win this football game. And there's a big play for Morgan County.
Big loss there. Big play on defense for the Cougars.
As they tackle Ian McCarty in the backfield. And a loss all the way back to the 39, so that's an 8-yard loss. And a big play for the Cougars defense, and now a big third and 12 for Morgan County, and let's see if the Cougars can get off the field here and get this football back. Get that football back and put it in the bread basket of Chance Wright and let him do the rest.
There you go.
Third and 12. Burchett fakes the handoff, and he's throwing it, and it's out of bounds. That pass was intended for Jenkins, and it goes over his head out of bounds. And that'll bring up fourth and 12 for the Hornets. So Morgan County gets the stop they was looking for.
And you will think that they would punt this ball away, but you never know. But it looks like they are going to punt it away.
So Sparks will kick this football away for the Hornets. And a good kick, and it bounces down inside the 25, and it'll roll dead at the 21.
So I don't think the Cougars were really ready for thinking that they were actually going to punt that. They was ready for the fake.
So a 31-yard kick for Sparks. The football's on the 21-yard line, and the Cougars will begin their fourth drive of this football game. Their first drive was three and out, but the last two times they've had the football, they've took it to the end zone both times. Joe Spencer with a beautiful catch from Blake Nickel in the right corner of the end zone for the first touchdown for Morgan County, and Chance Wright with a good run right up the gut on the last drive for a long touchdown run. We're tied at 12, and Morgan County has the football, and they're looking for their first lead of this game. Nickel takes the snap. And Jacob Nickel takes the toss.
Like he may have gained, what,
five yards as they mark it on the 26. So that is a five-yard gain. And it's second and five for Morgan County from that spot. Clock approaches a minute left here in the first period.
So a very exciting, high-scoring first quarter.
Very entertaining first quarter of football. Morgan County with two receivers here to the near side. Spencer in the slot. Nickel takes the snap. Hand off to Jacob Nickel and gives it back to Spencer. And Spencer goes out across the 25 to the 26-yard line. So with all that, we'll have no gain. And it'll be third and five from that spot. So Blake Nickel took the snap in the shotgun, handed it off to Jacob Nickel. Spencer was going back to the right. The second handoff went back to Joe, and he was tackled on the 26 for no gain.
And I think that the handoff to Joe wasn't real clean, so he kind of had to stutter step there to get the ball and slowed him down just a little bit.
Clock down under 20 seconds now as Nickel gets ready to take this snap. And he hands it off, and Wright goes across the 30. That'll be a first down. Actually, that's Cameron Rogers. Rogers the ball carrier, and that's a first down for Morgan County as he's an 8-yard gain to the 34-yard line. So first and 10 for the Cougars, and that's how we'll end the first period. Your score at the end of one here at Don McKenzie Field. Morgan County 12, Magoffin County 12. You're watching Morgan County Cougars football on the Morgan County Cougar Football Network.
I'm Kevin Anderson. I want to take this time to tell you the difference between my opponent and I. My opponent voted against a $106 million expansion of the Little Sandy Correctional Facility in Sandy Hook that costed Elliott County $1 million in payroll tax and 150 permanent jobs. He also voted against a $75 million Agritech Research and Development Center in Round County and $50 million in road projects. I will always vote for the betterment of the 99th District. Please vote for me, Kevin Anderson, on November 8th.
Hi, I'm Brock Littrell, president of Commercial Bank of West Liberty. For more than 100 years, we prided ourselves on treating our customers like family. The technologies we offer afford you the ability to bank with us from anywhere.
Hi, I'm Angie Pendergrass. I'm the CFO of Commercial Bank, and we are constantly looking for new technologies to improve our efficiencies and our bottom line, but more importantly, it allows us to spend more time with our customers.
Hi, I'm Howard Elam, CEO of Commercial Bank. I'd like to thank you for trusting us with your banking needs.
The team switch ends of the field. Morgan County will be moving from the right to the left now as we start the second quarter. They have the football first and 10 on their own 34-yard line, and this game's all knotted up at 12.
And a lot of purists like the defense part of the game, but I like offense. So it's been a fun game.
Handoff goes to Rogers. Big hole, and Cameron out across the 45. Another good run. He's still on his feet. Down into Magoffin County territory, and they'll mark him out at the 40. So that's a 26-yard gain. And another first and 10 for Morgan County. 26-yard run in Morgan County now with 13 rushes for 116 yards so far here in the first half. And, Steve, I'm telling you, this offensive line is opening up big holes for these running backs, and Rogers and Wright are taking full advantage of it.
They sure are. Big holes, and they're taking, like you say, they're taking advantage of it.
Before the snap, the flags fly, and that'll be a false start.
Yeah, that will cost them 5 yards. And
that'll back it up to the 45-yard line. And it's first and 15 now for the Cougars from the 45. And that's the only thing that slowed this Morgan County offense down is the flags.
Yep, it sure has, yep.
They've looked really good here tonight. The week off last week done them good. They've healed up and they're healthier right now than they have been for a little bit. And it shows here tonight.
It sure does.
Nickel in the gun. He's been there all night. Takes the snap, hands it off to Wright, and he's met it in the backfield, but he spins, and now he'll go down on about the 47-yard line. They'll give him forward progress, so a loss of two. Actually, they mark it now on the 46, so a loss of one, and that'll bring up second down and 16 now for the Cougars.
A very good spot if you're a Cougar fan and a bad spot if you're a Hornets fan there.
It was.
Yeah, so – lucky to only lose 1 yard there on that play.
Morgan County with 115 yards on the ground here on 14 carries so far in this game. Magoffin County with 104 yards on 12 rushes. So both of these teams are opening up big holes and running the football. And Morgan County has it second and 16, the ball on the 46-yard line of the Hornets. So Nickel in the gun, he's been there all night. He has a back to each side of him, two receivers to the near side, Spencer in the slot. Nickel floats it down the left side, and Spencer had the football in his hands, and then so did the Magoffin County defender, but it falls harmlessly to the turf. Incomplete. And, Steve, that ball was underthrown just a little bit.
Just a little. It got he got a little rush there, and he put a little air in it. He put it a little bit too much arch on it.
Joe had the defender beat. If the football hadn't had just quite as much air under it, points there.
He sure did. He had him beat.
So that stops the clock. 9:53 now left here in the first half. Morgan County with 3rd and 16 on the 46. Nickel again in the gun. Trip receivers to the far side. Empty backfield. 5 receivers. And he's in trouble. And Nickel will go down all the way back on the 42-yard line, it looks like. So a big sack there.
Yeah, the Hornets defense answered there. And, man, they were moving
loss.
Quick. So, yeah, they was moving quick there and got on him.
So a loss of 12 makes it 4th and 28 now, 4th and a mile.
Sparks back to receive.
Sparks way back there, standing inside his own 20. There's a snap, there's a touch.
And Rogers gets the kick away, and it bounces down inside the 30 and continues to roll. And the Hornets picked the football up, so they thought he was going to let it die, but he picks it up on the 20-yard line. And a good play by Matthew Sparks, a heads-up play, and he brings that football all the way back out.
I think he kind of used the referee as a screen.
He did.
He may play some basketball.
and he stood there, and I think the defenders went to sleep and thought, well, this ball's going to die, but he picks it up and runs it all the way back to the 38-yard line.
Yep. Smart play.
And it's 1st and 10 for Magoffin County from the 38. And a big run for Magoffin County there. Curtis Jenkins, and that's his second big run of the evening. They'll mark that all the way down. It looks like on the 30-yard line. 32-yard run, flips the ends of the field. And just like that, the Hornets are threatening again. They're 10 yards from the red zone, and they have it 1st and 10. Burchett hands it off to Lafferty, the big sweep around the left side. He turns the corner down inside the 10, still on his feet, and into the end zone goes Lafferty for the touchdown. So that didn't take long. Ben Lafferty with a 30-yard run. And Magoffin County bounces right back on top, 18-12 now over Morgan County at the 8:21 mark here of the second period.
Two big runs there by the Hornets.
14 rushes for 166 yards here in the first half for Magoffin County. They line up to go for two. And Jenkins will carry around the right side, turn the corner into the end zone for the 2 points. The conversion is good. And at the 8:21 mark left here in the first half, your score at West Liberty, Magoffin County 20, Morgan County 12, and we'll be back to Don McKenzie Field right after this.
Life is filled with moments, some monumental, some mere seconds. Moments we often take for granted as we worry and anticipate all the moments to come. At Woodman Life, we help ease that worry with our affordable insurance and retirement products. We work to protect financial security, community pride, patriotism, and peace of mind so that you can protect the moments that matter most.
Are you tired of the same old cell phone? Want a new phone, but really don't want to pay the hundreds of dollars up front for it? Appalachian Wireless has a deal for you. Get the phone you actually want instead of settling for a cheaper phone with the Appalachian Advantage Plan. Instead of paying $600 or more for the best phone, simply pay the taxes up front and then a few bucks a month more on your monthly bill. Stop by your local Appalachian Wireless store or dealer today for more information. It's the better, simpler way to pay. And it's called the Appalachian Advantage because we are you. We are Appalachian Wireless.
Nickel and Rogers are back deep on about the 25-yard line for Morgan County as Ben Lafferty gets ready to kick the football away. Magoffin County just made it to the end zone for the third time here in the first half, and Steve, they regain the lead 20-12 with a 2-point conversion over the Cougars.
And the Cougars defense give up two big plays there on that drive.
That football goes out of bounds, so Lafferty kicks it out of bounds, and that'll automatically come out. to the 35-yard line. And that's where Morgan County will begin this possession. So if you like offense, folks, you're enjoying this game here this evening.
Yep, good game for offense here.
Morgan County with 126 yards of offense here already in the first half, 103 yards of it on the ground on 15 carries. Magoffin County with 215 yards of offense, 169 of it on the ground. And there's been big runs galore on both sides, Steve.
They sure have.
First and 10, nickel in the gun, a back to each side, two receivers here to the near side. Spencer in the slot. Hand off Rogers across the 35. He's still on his feet, spins out over the 40, and they'll mark him at the 44-yard line.
Just short of the first down.
So good run for Cameron Rogers. They're going to give him 9 yards, and that'll bring up second down and one.
And again, we got a break in the action here. I guess do want to remind everybody that we are having an auction tomorrow. It's at the Morgan County Fairgrounds. We got 6 trucks to auction off, some office furniture, and some other items. So 10 o'clock in the morning, get there a little early, get to look over the items. We'll see you at the Fairgrounds, Morgan County Fairgrounds on 172.
Nickel flips it to Nickel. Jacob Nickel takes it across midfield and down into Magoffin County territory.
That's definitely enough for a first down there for the Cougars.
So that goes all the way down to the 47-yard line of Magoffin County. That's a 9-yard gain, and that's a first down for Morgan County. So they move the chains. The Cougars on the move once again. They're on the Magoffin County side of the 50. They have the football first and 10. We're midway through the second period. Up the middle goes Chance Wright. And he's tackled. That was almost a horse collar tackle there as they bring Wright down. And he's slow to get up.
Yeah, that was a...
That's a 6-yard gain down to the 41. But he was tackled right around the neck.
Yeah, he took some punishment on that drive, on that run.
Second and 4 for the Cougars. Backs to each side of Nickel. 2 receivers to the right. Hand off right up the middle. And down to about the 37-yard line goes Rogers. Gain of 4 on the play. And that was a hard 4 yards.
Yep. So, again, they got a 3rd and 1 here.
And we have a timeout on the field, it looks like, I believe. That was a first down. That's what I was getting ready to say. It was first and 10. But, you know, these officials have had problems spotting the football tonight. I hate to, you know, I hate to talk about that. But that's 3 times now. And this program was showing first and 10 with that run. They were showing 3rd and 1. So,
yep.
1st and 10 for the Cougars. They did move the chains. Rogers did with that 4-yard run. Nickel in the gun. He's been there all night. 2 receivers to the far side. 2 backs, 1 either side. Nickel keeps the football. Tries to turn the corner to the right, and he's going to be tackled. Keeps going backwards. And a flag comes down as well. So let's sort all this out and see what happens.
So it looks
that's
like
about a 14-yard loss if they mark him back where he was tackled on the 49 of Morgan County. But there was a flag. I saw an indication of a face mask. And I believe that was against Magoffin County, but we'll see.
Yep.
It is a face mask against Magoffin County. They're marking it from the 47-yard line of Magoffin County. So it's a 5-yard face mask.
Yeah, so it's 5-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. So ball's on the 42.
So that was on the 47-yard line, and they mark it to the 42 now. But that still makes it 1st and 15 after all that, a 5-yard loss. So Nickel in the gun. This handoff goes to Rogers. Quick hitter down inside the 40, the 35, and Cameron spins to the 34-yard line, so an 8-yard gain for Rogers there. And it's second down and 7. Football on the 34-yard line.
So the second effort there got him probably 4 more yards.
8 carries for 77 yards for Chance Wright and a touchdown. 7 carries for 59 yards for Cameron Rogers here in the first half. Rogers again. This time he goes down to about the 32-yard line, so give Cameron 2 on that carry. And that'll bring up 3rd and 5. Chance Wright comes back into the huddle now. He'll give Rogers a break. And those two boys have run the football well, Steve, here in the first half.
They sure have.
Between them, they've had 16 carries, both of them 8 carries apiece. Chance Wright, 77 yards and a touchdown. And Cameron Rogers has had 61 yards on the ground. Clock continues to move. We're down inside 5 minutes now left in the first half. Morgan County with 132 yards of offense on the ground on 20 carries here in the first half. Two receivers to the far side. Nickel takes the snap, hands it off. Up the middle goes Rogers again, and he's down inside the 30 to the 25. Down inside the 25, and that's another first down for Morgan County.
That'll be enough for a first down.
Mark it at the 24, so that's an 8-yard gain for Rogers. And they continue to gash this Magoffin County defense.
Got a couple good blocks there, had a hole, and he found it and got the first down. Good run.
First and 10 Cougars, the football on the 24. They're 4 yards away from entering the red zone again. And this Morgan County offense, after the first possession of the evening, was 3 and out. They've scored every time they've touched the football since. First and 10, a back to each side of Nickel. He hands it off to Wright this time. Another big hole down inside the 20. Chance still on his feet. They push the pile, and they'll stop him on about the 18-yard line, so a gain of 6. And that'll bring up 2nd down and 4 for the Cougars.
Seems like Morgan County's getting that second effort on these runs and getting an extra 2 or 3 yards. So got 6 on that one. So that little extra effort, instead of it being 2nd and 7, it's 2nd and 4.
2nd and 4.
So. And they are in the red zone now.
They are in the red zone. 2 receivers here to the near side. Spencer in the slot. Nickel takes the snap. And he's looking for Spencer in the end zone. And he's got it. Touchdown. Joe Spencer with an 18-yard catch and the touchdown. From Nickel in the second touchdown reception of the first half for Spencer. And just like that, Morgan County answers Magoffin County with a touchdown drive, and they're within 2 at 20-18.
I was a little worried that ball had a little bit too much air again, but it was just right. It was perfect.
It fell just perfect. Spencer had to wait on it, but he went up and got it.
He sure did. And it being senior night, it's good for Joe. Hey, that's 2 TDs for him tonight.
Joe with 2 touchdowns here in the first half and 50 yards in passing in the first half here for Nickel as they line up to go for 2. And up the middle goes Wright, and he crosses the goal line for the touchdown as he took the direct snap. It's good. And Morgan County answers Magoffin County with a touchdown and a 2-point conversion with 3:07 left here in the first half. Morgan County 20, Magoffin County 20. We'll be back to West Liberty right after this.
Standifer Builders is the area's best general contracting and paving company, serving you since 1965. We're family-owned and operated, and we're ready to meet your needs. Our friendly and experienced staff has the expertise to do the job right, no matter the size. We offer residential and commercial paving without the hassle of a big contractor. Call us today to schedule your free estimate. Standifer Builders is a proud supporter of local high school sports. Good luck to all athletes this season.
We'll be right back.
little TNT playing here across the PA system as Sexton lines up to kick off for Morgan County. And Sparks is deep for Magoffin County. 20-20, all even here in a very entertaining first half of football.
Yeah, that song had the kind of had the mood of everything going on right now.
Sexton squib kick goes out of bounds on the 24, so they'll bring that out to the 35-yard line. And Magoffin County will begin this drive on their own 35. So, Steve, Morgan County has stopped Magoffin County here and forced them to punt one time, but this has been, for all intents and purposes, an offensive show by both teams. As we have a timeout, Morgan County takes it. We'll take it with them. We'll be back to Don McKenzie Field in just a moment.
My name is Zach Engel, and I'm the branch manager here at First National Bank in West Liberty. Everyone here is excited to cheer on the Morgan County football team and its cheerleaders this upcoming season. Go Cougars!
First National Bank is committed to providing quality services to our customers. First National Bank offers a wide variety of account options. When you need a loan, First National Bank offers an assortment of loan options. We are excited to offer our home equity line of credit loans with zero closing costs. Stop by today and ask one of our knowledgeable team members for more information on our banking products.
First and 10 for the Hornets, 3:07 left here in the first half, and it's been a good first half of football.
Yeah, very exciting. Kind of like this play right here.
Ben Lafferty on the sweep, tuck it around the left side, and that'll move the chains for Magoffin County as they'll mark that on the 46-yard line, so that's an 11-yard gain for Lafferty, and first and 10 for the Hornets. Yep. So Magoffin County with a trio of running backs all over 50 yards here in the first half. They have it first and 10 on their own 46. And we're going to have a flag, and that's going to be penalty against Magoffin County.
Yeah, usually that's false illegal start, procedure. Yeah. Both so teams have had a few penalties. Seems like it hasn't really hurt them any.
That'll back it up to the 41. That's the only thing that slowed them down is offensive penalties. Both of these teams has marched up and down the field.
They sure have.
Handoff in the big hole down to the Morgan County side of the field and still on his feet, and he's going to go all the way in for the touchdown. No flags on the field. 59-yard run for the Hornets, Curtis Jenkins. My goodness, what a run. 59-yard touchdown run for Jenkins. And just like that, Magoffin County's back on top 26-20. And they're going to have to bring the oxygen out for both of these teams on offense to catch their breath in between drives with drives like that. Magoffin County lines up to go for two. Burchett takes the snap, hands it off. They try the sweep around the left side, and it's no good as Lafferty's tackled in the backfield. So with 2:09 left in the first half, a very entertaining first half at Don McKenzie Field, Magoffin County 26, Morgan County 20. You're watching Cougars football on MTTV.
I'm Kevin Anderson. I want to take this time to tell you the difference between my opponent and I. My opponent voted against a $106 million expansion of the Little Sandy Correctional Facility in Sandy Hook that costed Elliott County $1 million in payroll tax and 150 permanent jobs. He also voted against a $75 million Agritech Research and Development Center in Round County and $50 million in road projects. I will always vote for the betterment of the 99th District. Please vote for me, Kevin Anderson, on November 8th.
Caney Valley Propane, located near West Liberty, is here to take care of all your propane needs. We offer tank fill-ups for home or business. Stop by our office and we can fill up your cylinders too. Need an upgrade or don't have a propane system?
we can set you up with a new efficient system for your home or business. We also sell and service wall heaters, fireplaces, and gas logs. So don't get left in the cold. Call Caney Valley Propane.
Little high voltage rock and roll now, Steve, from ACDC is Magoffin County's Ben Lafferty gets ready to kick this football away. It's 26-20. The Hornets with the lead, and Lafferty's foot has to be sore from kicking this football so much here in the first half.
Yeah, we've got exciting music for an exciting game here. I tell you what, it's a lot of points and no running clock tonight.
Lafferty with a short kick taken by the up man on the 34. And that was Jacob Nickel. They'll have the football on about the 39-yard line, I believe. It's like the 38.
Yeah.
So that was a 4-yard return of the short kick. And the Cougars will start this possession 62 yards from pay dirt, and they trail by 6, 26-20. They have 2 minutes and 5 seconds left here in the first half to try to get this football in the end zone. And Steve, Magoffin County's not stopped them since the first drive.
Nope, sure have not. They've the Cougars' offense has been a different team after that first drive.
So Nichols been in the gun all night. He has a back to each side, two receivers here to the near side. Spencer in the slot, hand off to Rogers, and he's met head on at the 40-yard line. They'll give him 2 yards on the carry. And it'll be second down and 8 for the Cougars from the 40. Rogers with 10 carries for 69 yards here in the first half. Chance Wright, 9 carries for 83 yards, and he has a touchdown for the Cougars. As Nickel comes back into the huddle. In no hurry, the Cougars have 2 timeouts left on the scoreboard. They trail by 6, and it's 2nd and 8. 2 receivers here to the near side. Hand off to Rogers. Hole closes quickly, and Rogers is tripped up as he crosses the 40, and they'll mark him, looks like, on the 43-yard line. So a 5-yard gain. And that'll make it 3rd and a long 5 or 5 and a half for the Cougars as they've got to get to the out across the 48-yard line for a first down. Clock down under 50 seconds now as Nickel takes this snap. Fakes the handoff to Rogers, and he's floating it down the right side, and lots of contact there, no flag. And the ball falls incomplete. And Dakota Arnett was the intended receiver. And the incomplete pass brings up 4th and 5 with 41.8 seconds left here in the first half.
Another good strong throw.
There was contact there. It looked like it was probably incidental contact, but there was a lot of contact.
Yep, seemed like it went both back and forth there a little bit.
It did. Probably a no flag was good, I mean.
It's probably true, yep.
So it's 4th and 4, the football on the 44. They moved that football up a yard there. I mean, these officials, I don't know what they had to drink tonight before this game started. That was Spencer that took the second handoff, and he stopped on the 45-yard line. Actually, he'll mark it at the 44.
So that will give the ball
back. That's a change of possession, and Magoffin County has 36 seconds left now, and the football on the Morgan County side of the 50. They've got time to score.
Yeah, that's one thing for Magoffin. It hasn't really took them very long at all. That last drive was less than a minute.
They have 2 timeouts, too. We have an injured Cougar down on the field, so we'll take a timeout when we come back to West Liberty. 26-20, Magoffin County.
Life is filled with moments, some monumental, some mere seconds. Moments we often take for granted as we worry and anticipate all the moments to come. At Woodman Life, we help ease that worry with our affordable insurance and retirement products. We work to protect financial security, community pride, patriotism, and peace of mind so that you can protect the moments that matter most.
So Braxton Sexton, the injured Cougar, and they assist him off the field now. And he holds that left foot and ankle up off the ground, Steve.
You never want to see that. And hopefully nothing major, but it's not looking good right now.
So as they get Sexton to the sideline, Magoffin County has the football first and 10 on the Morgan County 44. They've got 242 yards of rushing here in the first half on 18 carries, 46 yards through the air. So 290 yards of offense for Magoffin County and 26 points here in the first half. Morgan County not far behind, 205 yards of offense and 20 points, 46 points here in the first half, and we're not done yet. Jenkins with the quick hitter down inside the 40. And I'll tell you, Steve, Curtis Jenkins is a runner.
He sure is.
He hits the hole fast, and he lowers his shoulder, and, buddy, he'll run over you.
Yep.
Five-yard gain, second down five, and Magoffin County takes a timeout. We'll take it with them. We'll be back to West Liberty right after this.
I'm Kevin Anderson. I'm running for state representative in the 99th District. I am for the working people in our area. My opponent voted to cut unemployment from 20 weeks to 12 weeks. He was the only legislator, Republican or Democrat, in Eastern Kentucky to cast that vote. I will always stand with the working class people of the 99th District. I humbly ask for your vote on November 8th.
To 20, Magoffin County with the lead and the football. They have one timeout left, and they're trying to build on this six-point lead, Steve, here before halftime.
And I do believe they get the ball back to start the second half.
They do. Burchett throws that football, and it falls incomplete. The pass was intended for Garrett Jenkins.
See, it looked like that ball bounced right up to him, and he scooped it in. And
it'll be third and five, and that's probably a good thing it was incomplete because it stops the clock. Magoffin County, they're still showing two timeouts on the scoreboard, but I think they only have one left. I believe that was their second timeout of the first half. So it's third and five, the football on the 39. Burchett in the shotgun, hands it off to Lafferty. He runs that sweep around the left side, goes out of bounds down inside the 40 at the 38-yard line, it looks like.
Yeah, not enough for the first down there.
So fourth and four now for Magoffin County, 19.8 seconds left on the clock here in the first half. Burchett in the gun, a back to each side. And McCarty with the handoff. They wasn't expecting that, and he's down inside the 30. That'll be a first down. They'll mark it at the 26-yard line, so that's a 12-yard gain. And let's see what the flag's all about here. It was a first down the way it stands, but if this flag's on Magoffin County, it'll back it up.
It was a Magoffin County player there with his arms up like, you know, what did I do? So maybe going back.
It's a personal foul against Magoffin County. So that'll be a 15-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. And that backs it up to the 41-yard line. So the personal foul penalty. Backs it up to the 41-yard line, and after all that, it'll be fourth down and seven on the 41 now for Magoffin County. 12.9 seconds is all we've got left here in the first half. And the Hornets will get the football, like Steve said, here out of the intermission to start the second half. And these officials have really had a lot of trouble here tonight.
Jenkins with the handoff. He's got a big hole down inside the 30, still on his feet inside the 20, and goes out of bounds at the 15-yard line. So a 26-yard gain for Jenkins.
So they got enough time for one more play here.
Football on the 15-yard line. Birch is throwing it into the end zone, and that pass is batted up, and I believe it's picked off, and it is by Jacob Nickel. So a good defensive play by Jacob Nickel to end the first half with the interception.
Good defensive play there by Nickel.
And he intercepted that all the way down on the 2-yard line. And that'll be the last play of the first half. So we come to the end of a very entertaining and quick-moving first half of football here at Don McKenzie Field. Your score at halftime, Magoffin County 26, Morgan County 20. We'll go back to the studio, and we'll be back here in a few minutes to go over all the first half statistics and get you ready for the second half from Don McKenzie Field.
Hi, I'm Brock Littrell, president of Commercial Bank of West Liberty. For more than 100 years, we've prided ourselves on treating our customers like family. The technologies we offer afford you the ability to bank with us from anywhere.
Hi, I'm Angie Pendergrass. I'm the CFO of Commercial Bank, and we are constantly looking for new technologies to improve our efficiencies and our bottom line, but more importantly, it allows us to spend more time with our customers.
Hi, I'm Howard Elam, CEO of Commercial Bank. I'd like to thank you for trusting us with your banking needs.
My name is Zach Engel, and I'm the branch manager here at First National Bank in West Liberty. Everyone here is excited to cheer on the Morgan County football team and its cheerleaders this upcoming season. Go Cougars!
First National Bank is committed to providing quality services to our customers. First National Bank offers a wide variety of account options. When you need a loan, First National Bank offers an assortment of loan options. We are excited to offer our home equity line of credit loans with zero closing costs. Stop by today and ask one of our knowledgeable team members for more information on our banking products.
The Citizens Bank is a locally owned bank that offers totally free checking for everyone. No hoops, no hassle. With our totally free checking, enjoy banking on the go with mobile banking, mobile deposit, bill pay, and the ability to send money to friends, family, and coworkers instantly with Zelle for free. Call or stop by today at one of our five banking centers for more information. The Citizens Bank, member FDIC.
Caney Valley Propane, located near West Liberty, is here to take care of all your propane needs. We offer tank fill-ups for home or business. Stop by our office and we can fill up your cylinders too. Need an upgrade or don't have a propane system? We can set you up with a new, efficient system for your home or business. We also sell and service wall heaters, fireplaces, and gas logs. So don't get left in the cold. Call Caney Valley Propane.
Life is filled with moments, some monumental, some mere seconds. Moments we often take for granted as we worry and anticipate all the moments to come. At Woodman Life, we help ease that worry with our affordable insurance and retirement products. We work to protect financial security, community pride, patriotism, and peace of mind so that you can protect the moments that matter most.
Standifer Builders is the area's best general contracting and paving company, serving you since 1965. We're family-owned and operated, and we're ready to meet your needs. Our friendly and experienced staff has the expertise to do the job right, no matter the size. We offer residential and commercial paving without the hassle of a big contractor. Call us today to schedule your free estimate. Standifer Builders is a proud supporter of local high school sports. Good luck to all athletes this season.
For nearly 50 years, Bank of the Mountains has served Morgan and the surrounding counties, working hard to provide our customers with friendly service and the financial products that make their lives easier. As a family-owned bank, we understand that relationships matter. We appreciate those who have chosen us to be their bank and invite those who haven't to stop by at any of our three locations, West Liberty, Index, or Ezel. Local people, local decisions, local commitment. Bank of the Mountains is proud to be a real community bank.
Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
I'm Kevin Anderson. I'm running for state representative in the 99th District. I am for the working people in our area. My opponent voted to cut unemployment from 20 weeks to 12 weeks. He was the only legislator, Republican or Democrat, in Eastern Kentucky to cast that vote. I will always stand with the working class people of the 99th District. I humbly ask for your vote on November 8th.
Back here at Don McKenzie Field, it's halftime of what's been an excellent first half of football. If you like offense, this is the place to be tonight here in West Liberty. 26-20, Magoffin County with a six-point lead at halftime. And let's see how we got to where we're at. These two teams both put 12 points each on the scoreboard in the first quarter. The scoring was started on the evening by Ian McCarty from Magoffin County. He had a 20-yard touchdown rush, and the Hornets led this game 6-0 as the two-point conversion failed. Morgan County answered right back from that scoring drive. Joe Spencer with an 18-yard pass reception from Bradley Nickel. The two-point conversion failed, and we were tied at 6 at that point. Magoffin County High School comes right back with Ian McCarty and an 11-yard touchdown run. They led 12-6 at that point before Morgan County closed out the scoring in the first period. Chance Wright with a 32-yard run, a beautiful touchdown run for Wright, and that tied this game at 12, and that's where we were at the end of the first quarter. In the second period, 22 points of offense put on the clock or on the scoreboard in the second period. Magoffin County with the first score in the second period. Ben Lafferty with a 30-yard touchdown run, and that put Magoffin County up 18-12. And then Curtis Jenkins had the 3-yard rush for the conversion. And at that point, Magoffin County had the lead at 20-12. Morgan County, however, would answer right back. This time, Joe Spencer again, 18-yard pass from Bradley Nickel, 20-18. Chance Wright up the middle with the 2-point conversion. And we were all even at 20. Then Magoffin County closed out the scoring in the first half as Curtis Jenkins took the football 59 yards on the run, and it was 26-20 at that point, and that's where we stand here at halftime. Let's look at some of the team and individual statistics in the first half. First, let's look at Magoffin County. They had 9 first downs in the first half. They rushed the football 17 times for 262 yards in the first half. Curtis Jenkins led Magoffin County in carries and yardage in the first half. He touched the football 8 times on the ground for 150 yards and a touchdown for Magoffin County. Ben Lafferty had 4 rushes for 57 yards. He also had a touchdown on the ground. And Ian McCarty had 5 carries for 55 yards and a pair of touchdowns in the first half for Magoffin County. The Hornets with 4 touchdowns in the first half on the ground. Passing for Magoffin County, Dason Burchett. He put the football up 4 times. He had 1 completion, but it was for 46 yards, and that was to Bryce Stanifer. So they had 46 yards of passing in the first half to go with their 262 yards on the ground. A total of 308 yards, Steve, in offense in the first half for Magoffin County.
And a very, very clean game for both teams. Not a lot of mistakes on offense.
really one turnover was at the very end of the first half, was that interception, which was a beautiful interception by Nickel there for Morgan County. But it really didn't, you know, it was the clock was running out, 2 seconds, 1 second, you know, and really didn't amount to anything. But really clean plays, play by both teams.
It certainly was. Magoffin County had 6 penalties in the first half for 46 yards. Now we flip the script and look at Morgan County. The Cougars put up 20 points in the first half. They had 11 first downs, 23 rushes for 146 yards for Morgan County. They had an excellent first half on the ground. Chance Wright led Morgan County in rushing in the first half, 9 rushes for 83 yards and a touchdown. Cameron Rogers had 11 carries for 74 yards. Joe Spencer, 2 carries for 1 yard. And Bradley Nickel had 1 carry for a 12-yard loss. And that's the 146 yards of rushing in the first half for Morgan County. 4 receptions for Morgan County in the first half for 50 yards. Joe Spencer with 2 of those, 36 yards, and a pair of touchdowns for Joe Spencer from Nickel. And Jacob Nickel also had 2 receptions for 14 yards. That's the 50 yards in passing. So 196 yards in offense for Morgan County in the first half. 4-7 passing for Blake Nickel, 50 yards. Third down conversions, Morgan County was 3-6 on those in the first half. Magoffin County, surprisingly, was 0-4 on third down, but they was 2-2 on fourth down conversions. Morgan County was 0-3 on fourth down conversions. So that's where we're at. It's halftime. Magoffin County with a 6-point lead, 26-20. We'll take a break and try to catch our breath, and we'll get ready to come back and show you an exciting second half of football. You're watching Morgan County Cougars football at Don McKenzie Field in West Liberty, and we'll be back right after this.
I'm Kevin Anderson. I'm running for state representative in the 99th District. I am for the working people in our area. My opponent voted to cut unemployment from 20 weeks to 12 weeks. He was the only legislator, Republican or Democrat, in Eastern Kentucky to cast that vote. I will always stand with the working class people of the 99th District. I humbly ask for your vote on November 8th.
For nearly 50 years, Bank of the Mountains has served Morgan and the surrounding counties, working hard to provide our customers with friendly service and the financial products that make their lives easier. As a family-owned bank, we understand that relationships matter. We appreciate those who have chosen us to be their bank and invite those who haven't to stop by at any of our 3 locations, West Liberty, Index, or Ezel. Local people, local decisions, local commitment. Bank of the Mountains is proud to be a real community bank.
Member FDIC. Equal Housing Lender.
Caney Valley Propane, located near West Liberty, is here to take care of all your propane needs. We offer tank fill-ups for home or business. Stop by our office and we can fill up your cylinders too. Need an upgrade or don't have a propane system? We can set you up with a new, efficient system for your home or business. We also sell and service wall heaters, fireplaces, and gas logs. So don't get left in the cold. Call Caney Valley Propane.
The Citizens Bank is a locally owned bank that offers totally free checking for everyone. No hoops, no hassle. With our totally free checking, enjoy banking on the go with mobile banking, mobile deposit, bill pay, and the ability to send money to friends, family, and coworkers instantly with Zelle for free. Call or stop by today at one of our 5 banking centers for more information. The Citizens Bank, member FDIC.
Are you tired of the same old cell phone? Want a new phone, but really don't want to pay the hundreds of dollars up front for it? Appalachian Wireless has a deal for you. Get the phone you actually want instead of settling for a cheaper phone with the Appalachian Advantage Plan. Instead of paying $600 or more for the best phone, simply pay the taxes up front and then a few bucks a month more on your monthly bill. Stop by your local Appalachian Wireless store or dealer today for more information. It's the better, simpler way to pay. And it's called the Appalachian Advantage because we are you. We are Appalachian Wireless.
Life is filled with moments, some monumental, some mere seconds. Moments we often take for granted as we worry and anticipate all the moments to come. At Woodman Life, we help ease that worry with our affordable insurance and retirement products. We work to protect financial security, community pride, patriotism, and peace of mind so that you can protect the moments that matter most.
I'm Kevin Anderson. I'm running for state representative in the 99th District. National politics haven't shaped me. What has made me the man I am today are the people of this district, from family to Sunday school teachers to farmers and county officials. I've practiced integrity throughout my campaign by speaking honestly. Integrity has the power to build trust, so you will have a greater confidence in me as your representative. If you want a positive leader who will fight for the people of the 99th District, I respectfully ask for your vote on November 8th.
Standifer Builders is the area's best general contracting and paving company, serving you since 1965. We're family-owned and operated, and we're ready to meet your needs. Our friendly and experienced staff has the expertise to do the job right, no matter the size. We offer residential and commercial paving without the hassle of a big contractor. Call us today to schedule your free estimate. Standifer Builders is a proud supporter of local high school sports. Good luck to all athletes this season.
Hi, I'm Brock Littrell, president of Commercial Bank of West Liberty. For more than 100 years, we've prided ourselves on treating our customers like family. The technologies we offer afford you the ability to bank with us from anywhere.
Hi, I'm Angie Pendergrass. I'm the CFO of Commercial Bank, and we are constantly looking for new technologies to improve our efficiencies and our bottom line, but more importantly, it allows us to spend more time with our customers.
Hi, I'm Howard Elam, CEO of Commercial Bank. I'd like to thank you for trusting us with your banking needs.
My name is Zach Engel, and I'm the branch manager here at First National Bank in West Liberty. Everyone here is excited to cheer on the Morgan County football team and its cheerleaders this upcoming season. Go Cougars!
First National Bank is committed to providing quality services to our customers. First National Bank offers a wide variety of account options. When you need a loan, First National Bank offers an assortment of loan options. We are excited to offer our home equity line of credit loans with zero closing costs. Stop by today and ask one of our knowledgeable team members for more information on our banking products.
I'm Kevin Anderson, and I want to take this time to tell you the difference between my opponent and I. My opponent voted against a $106 million expansion of the Little Sandy Correctional Facility in Sandy Hook that costed Elliott County $1 million in payroll tax and 150 permanent jobs. He also voted against a $75 million Agritech Research and Development Center in Round County and $50 million in road projects. I will always vote for the betterment of the 99th District. Please vote for me, Kevin Anderson, on November 8th.
Forty-eight, 34, 64, 44, 32, 38, 47. That's the score of the winning team when these two teams meet all the way back to 2013. And we're well on our way to that tonight, Steve, as it's 26-20 here at halftime. Magoffin County with the 6-point lead, and they do get the football here to start the second half.
And it could be either team right now that wins this ball game. So it'll be an interesting, entertaining second half. Senior night, Joe Spencer, big game so far. Two touchdowns on the receiving end. So big senior night for Joe Spencer tonight.
Only thing that'll make it any better is if the Cougars can outscore Magoffin County here in the second half and win this game to bring this 2022 regular season to the end. Morgan County Cougars football being brought to you by Appalachian Wireless, Bank of the Mountains, Caney Valley Propane, Commercial Bank, Dave Eisen, candidate for Morgan County Judge Executive, First National Bank, Frederick Law Office, PLLC, Stanifer Builders, Vicki Oldfield, Realtor for Homeland Real Estate, The Citizens Bank, GNS Concrete and Metal Roofing Services, Woodman Life, Tony Smith, candidate for West Liberty City Council, Jim Gazay, candidate for Morgan County Judge Executive, and Kevin Anderson, candidate for the representative of the 99th District. Second half ready to go. Morgan County will kick it away, and here we go. And the squib kick is falling on at about the 36-yard line.
A couple of Hornets hit it. Couldn't get their hands on it there, but finally they do secure it.
So they'll mark the football on the 37-yard line. And that's where Magoffin County will begin the second half. And, Steve, they put on a show in the first half on the offensive side of the ledger. 320 yards of offense in the first half, 274 on the ground, and they start off on the ground here in the second half.
And they have been explosive as well. So some big plays from the Hornets tonight.
Ian McCarty with the 2-yard carry to the 39-yard line, and that brings up second down and 8 for Magoffin County. Second and 8 football on the 39-yard line. Second half just underway here at West Liberty, 26-20 Magoffin County. Jenkins had a big first half. He goes out across the 45 to the 46-yard line, so that's a 7-yard gain. As Cameron Rogers made the tackle for Morgan County. And Jenkins was a yard short of the first down, so it's 3rd and 1, the football on the 46.
And at first glance, I thought that was enough for it, but no, it's short of maybe just a little more than a yard.
Maybe a little bit more than a yard.
Yep.
Two backs in the backfield. And Curtis Jenkins has been a workhorse here for Magoffin County on the ground, and he has the first down. As he gets 3 tough yards, and they'll mark that, actually give him 4, and they'll mark it right on the midfield stripe. So Jenkins moves the chains for the Hornets, continues this first drive of the second half. And Magoffin County looks to build on this 6-point lead early in the third quarter.
Very important for the Cougars defense here to make a good stand and get a stop, get that ball back.
First and 10 now for the Hornets. The football resting on the midfield stripe. Burchett takes the snap. Hands it off to McCarty. He sweeps it around the right, turns the corner, still on his feet, down inside the 40, the 30, the 25, and McCarty will finally be taken down at the 23-yard line. So a 27-yard run for Ian McCarty, and that moves the chains again for Magoffin County. They'll mark it on the 22, so that's a 28-yard run, Steve, and they're picking up right where they left off.
And, again, that's another thing that the Cougars defensive has been guilty of all season, giving up that big play, and there it was again.
And that was Jenkins on the carry there. And the football's on the 15-yard line. So that's a gain of 7 for Jenkins.
Yeah, got him in the backfield there on that one.
So
good defense by the Cougars.
Carrier. And he stopped on the 15-yard line.
And it looks like a Hornet may be hurt as he limps off the field.
Too quiet. Let's hear it, fans.
So third and three now. The football on the 15-yard line for Magoffin County. They're in the red zone. Burchett keeps the football, and he's close to a first down as they bring him down on the 13. The official over on the far side is almost dead even with the chain, so we'll have to see where the spot is.
Yeah, I think he is just a little bit short.
Bring up fourth and short. Let's hear you, fans.
So definitely fourth and short here, just inches.
So fourth and inches, big play here. Jenkins down inside the 10-yard line, no problem, first down. Give him 9 yards as he goes all the way down to the 5-yard line. And it'll be first and goal for the Hornets. They'll mark it on the 6.
Was enough for a first down, be first and goal for the Hornets.
So let's see if the Cougars defense can get a stop here on the goal line stands here, I guess. First and goal for the Hornets.
McCarty down inside the 5. He stood up right at the goal line. They'll mark him just short on the 1-yard line.
Just about got in there.
So he needed 6. He got 5. And that'll bring up second down and goal. And we have a Magoffin County player down on the field and an official's timeout for that. Both teams go to the sideline. We'll take a quick commercial break when we come back to West Liberty, 26-20 Magoffin County.
Life is filled with moments, some monumental, some mere seconds. Moments we often take for granted as we worry and anticipate all the moments to come. At Woodman Life, we help ease that worry with our affordable insurance and retirement products. We work to protect financial security, community pride, patriotism, and peace of mind so that you can protect the moments that matter most.
Second down and goal now for Magoffin County, and that football, Steve, is just inches from the goal line. They look to go up by 2 scores. And the second down run, and they hold.
Actually, for a loss there.
Curtis Jenkins, and they push him back. Actually, he'll lose about a half a yard on that. So a good play by the Morgan County defense. It's back out to the 2, so they lose a yard there. Third and goal now, football on the 2, and wouldn't this be a great defensive stand here on the goal line?
Oh, yes, it would.
Magoffin County out of the end zone.
Oh, just missed him.
Lafferty turns the corner, and they stand him up, and he did not make it in.
I don't think so, no. No indication by the referee there for the
– They're going to mark Lafferty down and out of bounds. It looks like inside the 1-yard line again, just inside the 1-yard line. So it's fourth and goal now for Magoffin County from here. And a big play, the biggest play of the football game so far. What a goal line stand here for Morgan County if they can stop them one more time. Fourth and goal. A back to each side. Hand off up the middle, and Curtis Jenkins plows his way into the end zone. So the fourth time's the charm, and Curtis Jenkins takes it into the end zone for the touchdown.
Guess you and would give him a 1-yard run there?
Yes, a 1-yard run, and Magoffin County extends their lead to 12 at 32-20. So that was an extended drive, Steve. 5 minutes and 13 seconds that took off the clock. And Magoffin County puts 6 points on the board. They go for 2 here now. With the score. and going across the pylon to score is Curtis Jenkins. So Jenkins gets the two-point conversion as well. And at the 6:47 mark left here in the third quarter, Magoffin County now extends their lead to the largest of the night, 34-20, the Hornets with the 14-point lead. And we'll be back to Don McKenzie Field right after this.
I'm Kevin Anderson. I'm running for state representative in the 99th District. National politics haven't shaped me. What has made me the man I am today are the people of this district, from family to Sunday school teachers to farmers and county officials. I've practiced integrity throughout my campaign by speaking honestly. Integrity has the power to build trust, so you will have a greater confidence in me as your representative. If you want a positive leader who will fight for the people of the 99th District, I respectfully ask for your vote on November 8th.
Are you tired of the same old cell phone? Want a new phone, but really don't want to pay the hundreds of dollars up front for it? Appalachian Wireless has a deal for you. Get the phone you actually want instead of settling for a cheaper phone with the Appalachian Advantage Plan. Instead of paying $600 or more for the best phone, simply pay the taxes up front and then a few bucks a month more on your monthly bill. Stop by your local Appalachian Wireless store or dealer today for more information. It's the better, simpler way to pay. And it's called the Appalachian Advantage because we are you. We are Appalachian Wireless.
Noah Lewis tucked that kick on the 29-yard line. He advances it 6 yards out to the 35, and that's where Morgan County will begin their first drive of the second half, and they now trail Magoffin County by 14, 34-20. And, Steve, this is the farthest they've been down tonight.
Yeah, two scores. Sometimes in high school it's maybe three scores. A 14-point lead here for the Hornets.
First and 10 for the Cougars. Nickel in the gun, a back to each side. Two receivers to the far side. Handoff across the 35, still on his feet, and now he's pushed backwards. That was Chance Wright. Forward progress will move him out to the 38, so that's a 3-yard gain for Wright, and that'll bring up second and 7 for the Cougars. Coach Easterling has to be pleased with his offense here tonight. This is the best they've looked this year, Steve.
Yeah.
They put 50 points on the board when they went to Jackson County, but I still think they've looked a lot better here tonight than they did even at Jackson County.
Yeah, I think so. And, you know, and I think the quality of the team here, the defense on this this Hornets team is pretty good. And so, yeah, they've done it against a good defensive team here. So yeah, Coach Easterling has to be pleased with it.
And off the right again, and they stand him up this time. That forward progress might get him to the 40, and it looks like that's where they're going to mark it. So 2 yards for Wright on the carry there. Jenkins on the stop for Magoffin County, and that'll bring up 3rd and 5, the football on the 40-yard line.
So it looks like the Hornets has adjusted on that run up the middle. So it looked like there at one time the Cougars were having their way, running it up the middle. And so now the Hornets have adjusted and not allowed that.
Both teams have made adjustments at halftime. And I can tell you right now, this third quarter has already started a lot slower than the first half was, but it could be from offensive fatigue, too.
It could.
3rd and 5, football on the 40. Nickel in the gun. He's been there all night. Two receivers to the near side. Hand off to Wright. He crosses the 40. Forward progress will give him the 41-yard line. So a gain of 1 for Chance on that. And Morgan County's 4 yards short. They give him the 42, actually. So that's a 2-yard gain.
Yep.
We
got 4th and 3 for the Cougars. It's a generous spot there, I believe. But I guess we'll take it.
We'll take it. Fourth and 3, the football on the 42.
Looks like the Cougars are definitely going to go for it here.
Well, they don't really have a choice. I mean, they're down 2 scores for the first time, and they've not stopped this Magoffin County offense. So they need to try to keep pace. Big play here, 4th and 3. Nickel in the gun, 2 receivers to the far side. Hand off to Rogers. He crosses the 45, and he'll have the first down and move the chains as Cameron Rogers goes to the 47-yard line. So he needed 3, he got 5, and that's a first down for Cameron Rogers and the Morgan County Cougars and keeps the drive alive.
Big play there by the Cougars.
extend this drive. Just what they needed.
Just what they needed. First and 10 now. They're 2 yards short of the midfield stripe. They trail by 14.
Yeah, extend this drive, and maybe the Hornets defense may be getting a little fatigued, a little tired.
Two receivers to the far side, Spencer in the slot, Nickel in the gun. He's floating it down to Jacob Nickel, and oh, he had it in his hands, and it falls incomplete. A good defensive play there by the Magoffin County back.
And again, that
Dakota
throw.
Arnett had the football. I said Nickel to begin with, but it was Dakota Arnett. He had it in his hands, and the defender knocked it away.
Yep. Good throw. Good defense. But, yeah, it was right on the money.
So, second and 10. Again, two wide outs to the left, two backs, one to either side. Fakes the handoff to Rogers. Nickel keeps it. He's over into Magoffin County territory, down inside the 40, and Blake Nickel has the first down for the Cougars. Bradley Nickel with the carry all the way down to the 38-yard line. And a good run by Bradley there. 15 yards on the run, and now Bradley Nickel comes to the sideline limping. And it's first and 10 for Morgan County.
Yeah, being a Cougar fan, you don't want to see that.
Well, he's coming right back out now, so that's good.
Yeah.
So he's right back out in the huddle. But he's played a lot of games this year. He's been hurt and banged up all year.
Yeah, and tell you what, football's just rough. It's tough, and
it's ever a play there. Sport for sure.
It sure is.
First and 10 for the Cougars. Drive continues on the 38-yard line of Magoffin County. Nickel takes the snap, hands it off to Wright. Big hole for Chance down inside the 30, still on his feet, 25, 20, 15, 10, and he's down inside the 10-yard line to the 8, and a big run for Chance Wright, 20 yards on the run.
And a couple good moves there.
And it'll be first and goal. And they marked that football on the 9-yard line, so officially a 19-yard run. And it's first and 10 for the Cougars from the 9. Nickel fakes a handoff to Rogers, pitches it back to Rogers. He faked the handoff to.
It was a loss there, wasn't it?
It was. Rogers loses a yard on that.
Second and goal, so it's a little more than 10 yards, but not much more. Or no, it's actually, yeah, it's on the
11.
Yeah.
Well, it's just outside the 10-yard line.
Yeah. It's a long 10 yards.
It's a long 10 yards. Two receivers to the far side, Spencer in the slot where he's been most of the evening, Nickel in the gun. Right to his left, Rogers to his right. And Nickel's got Spencer wide open in the end zone. Touchdown, Joe Spencer. The hat trick for Spencer, his third touchdown of the evening. What a way to cap off senior night. Bradley Nickel, his third touchdown pass of the evening, all three of them to Joe Spencer. And Morgan County's pulled back to within 8. It's 34-26.
Yeah, Joe Spencer, have a game. Why don't you there? I'll tell you what.
He's had a heck of a game here.
He sure has.
Spencer now with 3 receptions for 46 yards and 3 touchdowns. So the hat trick for Spencer here to close out senior night for Morgan County. What a game he's had. Morgan County lines up to go for 2. And the handoff goes to Wright, and the 2-point conversion is no good. So with a minute and 10 seconds left in quarter number 3, your score, Magoffin County 34, Morgan County 26, and we'll be back to West Liberty right after this.
For nearly 50 years, Bank of the Mountains has served Morgan and the surrounding counties, working hard to provide our customers with friendly service and the financial products that make their lives easier. As a family-owned bank, we understand that relationships matter.
We appreciate those who have chosen us to be their bank and about those who haven't to stop by at any of our three locations, West Liberty, Index, or Ezel. Local people, local decisions, local commitment. Bank of the Mountains is proud to be a real community bank. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
My name is Zach Engel, and I'm the branch manager here at First National Bank in West Liberty. Everyone here is excited to cheer on the Morgan County football team and its cheerleaders this upcoming season. Go Cougars!
First National Bank is committed to providing quality services to our customers. First National Bank offers a wide variety of account options. When you need a loan, First National Bank offers an assortment of loan options. We are excited to offer our home equity line of credit loans with zero closing costs. Stop by today and ask one of our knowledgeable team members for more information on our banking products.
Joe Spencer with the 10-yard touchdown reception from Blake Nichols. Spencer's third touchdown catch of the night. And he gets the hat trick, Stephen, on senior night. What a way to close out your final home game, 34-26.
Definitely something he's going to remember.
Morgan County has cut this lead to 8. Now let's see if they can play some defense and stop this Hornets offense to get this ball back and try to tie this football game. Sexton will kick it off. Right down the middle of the field it goes, all the way down inside the 10. It's picked up by Sparks there at the 8. And he gets back to about the 19-yard line. Jace Atkins with the stop. And Sparks with the 11-yard return. They'll mark it. They'll mark it on the 19-yard line. And now the officials will gather up to have a discussion. We'll see what this is about. And that's a block in the back. So that'll back it up from the 19. We'll see where they take it to.
On the 14.
Football's at the 14-yard line.
Right. Good tackle there by Rogers.
So Rogers with the tackle, that's a gain of 7 for Rafferty. Football's on the 23-yard line. McCarty, the ball carrier, still on his feet. He turns the corner now, and there he goes. Out across the 40, still on his feet, and they'll take McCarty down just short of the midfield stripe. He steps out of bounds actually at the 44-yard line. So a 21-yard gain.
Big run there.
And a first down for Magoffin County. So first and 10, and the Hornets on the move again, Steve.
They sure are, and it's been the story of the night for them.
It's been the story of the night. First and 10, Magoffin County, the football on the 44. Jenkins, the ball carrier, this time he stopped for a short gain of maybe 1. And that'll be the final play of the third quarter. Your score at the end of 3. Magoffin County 34, Morgan County 26. You're watching Morgan County football on the Cougar Football Network.
My favorite time and all of our favorite time of the football season.
Hi, I'm Brock Littrell, president of Commercial Bank of West Liberty. For more than 100 years, we've prided ourselves on treating our customers like family. The technologies we offer afford you the ability to bank with us from anywhere.
Hi, I'm Angie Pendergrass. I'm the CFO of Commercial Bank, and we are constantly looking for new technologies to improve our efficiencies and our bottom line, but more importantly, it allows us to spend more time with our customers.
Hi, I'm Howard Elam, CEO of Commercial Bank. I'd like to thank you for trusting us with your banking needs.
I'm Kevin Anderson. I'm running for state representative in the 99th District. I am for the working people in our area. My opponent voted to cut unemployment from 20 weeks to 12 weeks. He was the only legislator, Republican or Democrat, in Eastern Kentucky to cast that vote. I will always stand with the working class people of the 99th District. I humbly ask for your vote on November 8th.
Curtis Jenkins is tackled at the 45-yard line for no gain as this fourth quarter gets underway. Actually, they'll give him one. They mark it at the 46.
And it's become a tradition at the beginning of the, in between the third and fourth quarter, they honor Donnie McKenzie, well-deserved.
So the football on the 46-yard line. Bad snap. Burchett picks it up, but he'll go out of bounds for a big loss after that bad snap. They'll mark him out all the way back at the inside the 35-yard line. Looks like the 34.
Yeah, big loss there for the Hornets.
So that was an 11-yard loss.
So it brings up fourth down. So
fourth down and long. Fourth and 17, the scoreboard says. I've got it fourth and 20, so anyway, it's fourth and a mile.
Yeah, and I would think they need to punt this ball.
And they will. Matthew Sparks will kick this football away, and Morgan County has a chance now to take this football down the field and tie this game. Good kick by Sparks with nobody back, and it'll take a good Magoffin County bounce down inside the 30, and it'll go dead on the 25-yard line. So a 49-yard kick flips into the field. And Morgan County will have the football. First and 10 on their own 25-yard line with 11:09 left in regulation time, and they trail Magoffin County 34-26. And Steve, here's the time of the game when you need to get tough, get your second breath, and march this football down the field, tie this game up.
They do. They need a big drive right here, and maybe Joe Spencer will get a couple more big plays here.
What's better than three touchdown catches? Four.
There you go.
Hand off to Rogers. Quick hitter, big hole. Cameron out across the 40, still on his feet into Magoffin County territory, down inside the 40, and they'll finally bring Rogers down at the 33-yard line. So a 43-yard run. All the way down to the 35-yard line. It's a 33 is where they officially mark it.
So the Cougars on the other end there have with a big play. So we'll see if they can keep this drive going.
First and 10 for the Cougars. They look to try to draw even in this game if they can score here. Jacob Nickel down inside the 30, down inside the 20. And he'll go out of bounds with another first down. And now a late flag comes in.
We do have a flag on the play.
So the football's marked on the 14-yard line. That was a 19-yard gain. And now let's see what the flag's all about.
So they're inside the red zone, and looks like the flag is, it looks like it's going to be on Magoffin.
It's an unsportsmanlike penalty, so that's half the distance to the goal line.
Yep.
So first and goal for Morgan County from the 7-yard line after the penalty's marked off. Pass is incomplete.
Almost intercepted there.
Almost intercepted.
Key word there is almost.
That's right.
It did not happen.
So second down and goal, the football on the 7-yard line.
Yeah.
Clock at 10:45 left in the fourth period. Nickel takes the snap. Hands it off to Rogers, and he's going to score.
He was in there.
So Cameron Rogers with the touchdown. And just like that, Morgan County's drawn back to within 2 points at 34-32.
So this two-point conversion here will be huge.
This is a huge two-point conversion, Steve. That's right. So 34-32. And the referee was talking to the Magoffin County coaches on their sideline.
You're going to take the penalty on the two-point conversion.
So the touchdown is good. The penalty against Morgan County is marked off for this two-point conversion. It's unsportsmanlike, a 15-yard penalty. So the long two-point conversion, the football's handed off in a big hole.
He's
and
got
going
it.
In for the two-point conversions, Cameron Rogers. What a play by Cameron Rogers after the 15-yard penalty was marked off. Rogers takes it all the way into the end zone for the two-point conversion and put a star by that play. At the 10:40 mark left in regulation, we're tied now. Morgan County 34, Magoffin County 34, and we'll be back to Morgan County High School right after this.
Caney Valley Propane, located near West Liberty, is here to take care of all your propane needs. We offer tank fill-ups for home or business. Stop by our office and we can fill up your cylinders too. Need an upgrade or don't have a propane system? We can set you up with a new, efficient system for your home or business. We also sell and service wall heaters, fireplaces, and gas logs. So don't get left in the cold. Call Caney Valley Propane.
Couldn't ask for a better game the way this game's been played to end a regular season. 34-34, we're all even. And Sexton's kickoff is smothered and recovered by Magoffin County on the 44-yard line.
A drive line right at him, wasn't it?
Line drive right at him.
And I don't think he was quite ready for it. But he wasn't
expecting the football there. But he done the smart thing. He didn't try to pick it up and run. He just fell on the football.
Exactly. That's what you're supposed to do there.
And here comes the Hornets. 34-34. We're all even. Magoffin County with the football on their own 44-yard line. And let's see if the Cougars defense can rise up and get another what would be a big stop here. Jenkins has been the workhorse tonight, one of them. He turns the corner. He's got a big run still on his feet down inside the 30, inside the 20. And he's knocked out of bounds. And let's see where they're going to say he went out at. Looks like the 21-yard line. So a 35-yard run for Jenkins. And a first down. So quickly now, Magoffin County's back in Morgan County territory, 1 yard outside the red zone. They're looking to take this lead back, and still a world of time left, 10:28 on the clock. Burchett hands it off to McCarty, and he spins, and he's drilled at the 20-yard line. Give him 1 yard. It'll be second down and 9 now for the Hornets.
This Cougar defense is looking for a stop, and head the other way with it.
We'll have less than 10 minutes on the clock when the football snaps this time, but the way these two teams have moved the football up and down the field, that's a world of time. Jenkins down inside the 20, and he's piled up at the 17, so a 3-yard gain. Third down and 6 now, the football on the 17. Curtis Jenkins with 17 carries for 208 yards and 2 touchdowns for Magoffin County. And we're not done yet.
No, still plenty of time left.
Third and 6. Rafferty makes 2 players miss, gets the corner, and goes down inside the 15 to the 10-yard line, and that's a first down. Ben Lafferty with the run. 7 yards on that run.
Yeah, good move there. There in the backfield and split the defenders and got the first down.
First and goal for Magoffin County. Football on the 10. 9:13 on the clock left in regulation. Burchett hands it off to Jenkins, and he goes right up the middle into the end zone. A 10-yard touchdown run for Curtis Jenkins. And Magoffin County scores again. 40-34 now, Magoffin County. Back on top by 6. And Jenkins has a hat trick, 3 touchdowns on the ground tonight, 18 carries for 218 yards, Steve.
Tell you what, the stat sheets are filling up here tonight for both teams.
Magoffin County will line up to go for 2. And Jenkins is going to be stopped. And now flags fly everywhere after the play.
Getting a little chippy right now.
2-point conversion is no good, and we have a personal foul offsetting against both teams. So with 9:08 left in regulation time, Magoffin County regains the lead 40-34, and we'll be back to Don McKenzie Field to watch the Morgan County Cougars take the football back right after this.
Standifer Builders is the area's best general contracting and paving company, serving you since 1965. We're family owned and operated, and we're ready to meet your needs. Our friendly and experienced staff has the expertise to do the job right, no matter the size. We offer residential and commercial paving without the hassle of a big contractor. Call us today to schedule your free estimate. Standifer Builders is a proud supporter of local high school sports. Good luck to all athletes this season.
Caney Valley Propane, located near West Liberty, is here to take care of all your propane needs. We offer tank fill-ups for home or business. Stop by our office and we can fill up your cylinders too. Need an upgrade or don't have a propane system? We can set you up with a new, efficient system for your home or business. We also sell and service wall heaters, fireplaces, and gas logs. So don't get left in the cold. Call Caney Valley Propane.
466 yards of offense for Magoffin County. They regain the lead 40-34. Morgan County with 340 yards of offense, and they're getting the football back here.
Looks like about the 35.
And it will be on the 35-yard line as Jacob Nickel tucked that kick. And Morgan County's offense will come back onto the field, and the Cougars will try to answer the score that Magoffin County just put on the board. And, Steve, I don't remember the last football game I saw like this. Morgan County, 37 rushes for 280 yards, but Magoffin County says, look at this, 46 rushes, 420 yards on the ground for Magoffin County.
Tell you what, yeah, the stat sheet is filled up tonight for both teams.
Chance Wright, big hole up the middle, crosses the 45 with a first down, and they'll mark him down at the 49-yard line, so a 14-yard gain for Chance Wright, and here comes the Cougars.
That'll be enough for a first down, Cougars!
You got to wonder maybe fatigue may play a factor here in this game here at the end.
Both of these defenses has to be tired. Yeah. They have to be tired.
And if you look over at that sideline for Magoffin County, there's not a whole lot of players over there. So they're playing both sides of the field.
Two receivers to the far side. Nickel fakes the handoff to right. He keeps it. Crosses the Magoffin County fifth or midfield, goes down to the Magoffin County side of the field at the 48-yard line. So a 3-yard run for Nickel. And that'll bring up second down and seven now for the Cougars. Clock approaches 8 minutes left in regulation time, and Morgan County's on the move once again. Two receivers to the near side, Spencer in the slot, handoff to Wright. He spins down inside the 45. They'll give him the 44-yard line, so Chance Wright with 3 yards on that carry. So third and three, the football on the 44. And Morgan County has got the answer, Steve. The way this game's going, you can't afford to get rid of the football without putting some points on the board.
Yeah, exactly. They've got to keep building here.
Nickel in the guns. Spencer in the slot. Two receivers to the near side, a back to each side of Nickel. Fakes the handoff to right, flips it to Jacob Nickel, and he goes down inside the 40.
Definitely for a first down there.
And they'll mark him at the 34-yard line, so a gain of 10 and a first down. Good run by Nickel. Moves the chains, and the Cougars are on the march inside the 35. Nickel in the gun. He's been there all night. Jacob Nickel to his left, Chance Wright to his right. He hands it off to Wright. Wright down inside the 30, another big hole. And he goes all the way down to the 26. That'll be about an 8-yard gain.
Not one, but it makes you think that maybe these coaches may think, I want the ball at the end. I want the ball at the very last. If I've got it, if I have it the last, I'll win it. So.
So second down and one, the football on the 25 as Morgan County breaks the huddle. Clock down under 7 minutes now. Nickel takes the snap, hands the football off to Cameron Rogers. Big hole down inside the 20, move the chains, first down all the way down to the 16. And a first down run for Cameron Rogers.
And again, they're back in the red zone.
Cougars back inside the red zone, first and 10. Football on the 16, 19 first downs for Morgan County in this game.
And they're wasting no time.
Nickel hands it off to Rogers. And another positive run down to the 11. Give him 5 yards on that carry.
Good run there.
It'll be second and five. And Magoffin County has a player down that's slow to get up. And that's Curtis Jenkins. But he's back on his feet and staying in the game. So the clock down under 6 minutes now left. And it's rolling. Morgan County second and five. They're on the 11-yard line and are looking to tie this game up here if they can put it in the end zone. Nickel again in the gun. Right to his left. Rogers to his right. Oh, he tried to flip it back to Chance Wright. The ball's loose and Nickel recovers it. But a big loss all the way back to the 35-yard line. So that's a 20, or that's a, on the 25-yard line, that's a 14-yard loss.
Yeah, that one hurts right there. Big loss.
And a big, big miscue there.
Yep. But really no worse on that than that 2-point conversion earlier.
That's true.
You know.
So that puts you way behind the chains now. Third and 19, the football on the 25. But, hey, they had an 18-yard run for a 2-point conversion just a few minutes ago.
Yep. And they're definitely going
to. They've got two plays to do this in, too. That pass is short, and it was almost intercepted as Nickel underthrew that ball. It was intended for Jace Atkins and almost intercepted. So now you bring up fourth down. You one play, you need 19 yards.
Yep, you got to get it all right here. Cannot be short.
Let's hear you, fans.
45 rushes on the evening in this game for Morgan County. 321 yards on the ground. Magoffin County has 420 yards on the ground.
Yep. So we'll see what the Cougars do here. Are they going to throw it in the air? Are they going to run it?
Fourth and 19. Here we go. Nickel in the gun. The back to each side. Two receivers to the far side. And they try the trick play with the double reverse, and Spencer's tackled in the backfield, and Morgan County will turn that football over. So that's a 7-yard loss.
Yeah, he got hit from the blind side there. I don't think he saw the defender behind him.
Let's see where the official spot this at. It looks like the 32. So a 7-yard loss, and Morgan County turns the football over on downs. Now the defense has to rise to the occasion.
They sure do. They have got to step up right here.
4:33 is all we've got left. If Magoffin County scores here, they'll be up by two scores. Jenkins turns the corner. Here he goes. Spins at the 40, and he's still on his feet and finally tackled at the 45-yard line, so a 13-yard gain. And a first down for Jenkins.
Move the chains.
18 first downs in the game now for Magoffin County. So we've had 37 first downs between these two teams here in this game. Clock moves 4:15. It'll be down under 4 minutes here at the end of this play. And right now the clock is a friend to Magoffin County.
And they know that, don't they?
They know that. All of a sudden they slow down.
Yeah. No hurry whatsoever.
McCarty spins. He's going to keep it in bounds. He'll lose a few yards, but the clock will continue to run, and there could have been a flag for a late hit on that. They'll mark that football on the 42, so that's a 3-yard loss. Second down, 13. Both teams with all three timeouts remaining. Lafferty crosses the 45, and a good run for positive yardage all the way out to the 49-yard line. That's 7 yards.
And probably got another 3 or 4 yards after the first hit.
Ben Lafferty's hard to tackle.
I tell you what, big kid. Got some speed, got some power.
Both he and Curtis Jenkins have took a lot of hits tonight, and they just keep on going.
Keep on going.
Third down and 7 now. Football on the 49. Clock down under 3 minutes. Two receivers to the far side. Two running backs.
On the stop for the Cougars.
Big stop.
Curtis Jenkins went nowhere on that carry. Big stop for Morgan County. And now the Cougars take a timeout as well. So they'll mark that football on the 48-yard line. So a 1-yard loss for Jenkins. That'll bring up 4th and 7. Morgan County's called a timeout. Let's take a 30-second break, and we'll be back to Don McKenzie Field right after this.
For nearly 50 years, Bank of the Mountains has served Morgan and the surrounding counties, working hard to provide our customers with friendly service and the financial products that make their lives easier. As a family-owned bank, we understand that relationships matter. We appreciate those who have chosen us to be their bank and invite those who haven't to stop by at any of our 3 locations, West Liberty, Index, or Ezel. Local people, local decisions, local commitment. Bank of the Mountains is proud to be a real community bank. Member FDIC. Equal housing lender.
Just a little respect, Steve.
Yeah,
that's
right.
What we want here. 4th and 7 for Magoffin County, Morgan County.
And if maybe the biggest play there by the defense there was 72 Bennett Ball. So he done a really good job there on that tackle on the backfield.
Biggest play of the game now, 4th and 7, and they'll kick it away.
And it's
Sparks' kick is partially blocked.
Picked up by Jacob Nichols.
And and it was picked up by Jacob Nickel. That ball was partially deflected. And it's taken on the 45-yard line, and that's where Morgan County will take over at on the change of possessions. First and 10, the football on the 45-yard line. All right, let's set you up. 40-34, Magoffin County with a six-point lead. Morgan County has the football. They have two of their three timeouts remaining, and they're 55 yards from tying this game.
And this is when it gets fun.
This has been by far the best, the most entertaining game we've seen this year.
Yeah, by far.
First and 10, Nickel in the gun. He's been there all night. Fakes the handoff to Rogers, now flips it to Jacob Nickel, and he turns the corner down inside the 40. Still on his feet, and he stumbles and falls. Jacob Nickel all the way down to the 33-yard line, a gain of 22 yards.
Man, big, big play there.
And a first down for Morgan County. So Jacob Nickel with a big run for Morgan County all the way down to the 34-yard line of Magoffin County, and that's a first down for the Cougars. And they're 33 yards away from tying this football game as we have an injured player down on the field.
Back on his feet now.
That's Curtis Jenkins, and he is back on his feet, and he's walking off under his own power, and that's a good sign.
That is a good sign.
And that kid is tired, Steve. He has ran the football like a warrior tonight, and he played both sides of the ball. And that's the second time he's been down here in the second half.
Yeah, it looks like on that sideline over there, there's probably not. There's less than 20 players for Magoffin right now. I mean, they don't have – they're very
– They have seven players on the sideline over there right now, make it eight now that Jenkins has went off.
Yep.
So 19 players is what they've got out here right now.
That's tough.
First and 10, football on the 33. The clock is moving. Nickel hands it off. Rogers down inside the 30. A big hole, 25, 20, still on his feet. And Rogers all the way down inside the 20 and back in the red zone go the Cougars. A 17-yard run. He was on the 34. He winds up on the 17. And it's first and 10 for Morgan County.
And the Cougars can kind of – they got the momentum going and – they're not letting up.
First and 10, Morgan County. Nickel in the gun. Motion everywhere. No flag. And Bradley goes down on the 17-yard line for no gain.
Probably the smart play there. No, nothing open, nothing going. So just
so
went
second
down.
And 10. And again, I thought Morgan County got away with motion there, Steve. It looked to me like there was two or three players that jumped right before the snap.
I tell you what, they've been several plays tonight. It's kind of been iffy.
Second and 10, football on the 17. Nickel in the gun. Two receivers to the near side. Spencer in the slot. Hand off to Rogers. He makes one tackle miss, still on his feet, and Rogers goes down to about the 15-yard line, and he turns a negative play into a positive and picks up 2 yards, and that'll bring up third down and about eight now.
Very easily, that could have been a loss.
That could have been a 2-yard loss or a 3-yard loss.
Yep.
Rogers made two players miss in the backfield. So third and eight, football on the 15, and we're down inside a minute now. What an ending and what a game.
What a ball game.
Third and eight, here we go.
Everybody on
Nickel
their feet.
In the gun, three wide outs this time, all to the near side here. Nickel rolls to the near side. He's floating it into the corner. The end zone, and the pass was caught and dropped. Incomplete to Jacob Nickel. And Jacob had it in his hands and couldn't hang on to it.
I don't think he saw the ball until the very last second there.
He either didn't see it or the lights blinded him. One of the two, it was on top of him before he seen it.
Yep.
So it's fourth and eight, 36.5 seconds is what we've got left. But here's your ball game right here.
And this is the biggest play of the game.
This is the biggest play of the game right here. This is the play of the game.
Yes, it is.
So the Morgan County Cougars season is coming to a dramatic conclusion, the regular season version anyway.
Now, they don't have to get a touchdown here. They can get 8 yards and get a first down and and get it in a couple more plays. But
they've got to have eight.
Yes.
They've got to make the 7-yard line. Nickel rolls to the near side. He's going to have to do something with it, and he throws it up for grabs and out of bounds. Incomplete intended for Spencer. And he was trying for that fourth touchdown pass of the evening to Spencer, but it goes incomplete. And Morgan County will turn the football over on downs. So Magoffin County has 29.1 seconds left to secure this victory. Morgan County with two timeouts.
His momentum going to the sideline, just that ball floated just out of bounds on him. It floated on him.
It did.
Which that turns the ball over on downs, gives the ball back to the Hornets.
So we have a timeout on the field. We'll take it with them when we come back to West Liberty, 40-34, Magoffin County.
Hi, I'm Brock Littrell, president of Commercial Bank of West Liberty. For more than 100 years, we've prided ourselves on treating our customers like family. The technologies we offer afford you the ability to bank with us from anywhere.
Hi, I'm Angie Pendergrass. I'm the CFO of Commercial Bank, and we are constantly looking for new technologies to improve our efficiencies and our bottom line, but more importantly, it allows us to spend more time with our customers.
Hi, I'm Howard Elam, CEO of Commercial Bank. I'd like to thank you for trusting us with your banking needs.
First and 10 for Magoffin County. They take the snap and a knee. And is Morgan County going to take a timeout? They are not. That'll be the final snap of the game. And your final score at Don McKenzie Field as the regular season comes to an end. The Magoffin County Hornets defeat Morgan County 40-34. And we'll be back to Don McKenzie Field right after this to wrap up this 2022 regular season.
I'm Kevin Anderson. I'm running for state representative in the 99th District. I am for the working people in our area. My opponent voted to cut unemployment from 20 weeks to 12 weeks. He was the only legislator, Republican or Democrat, in Eastern Kentucky to cast that vote. I will always stand with the working class people of the 99th District. I humbly ask for your vote on November 8th.
Are you tired of the same old cell phone? Want a new phone, but really don't want to pay the hundreds of dollars up front for it? Appalachian Wireless has a deal for you. Get the phone you actually want instead of settling for a cheaper phone with the Appalachian Advantage Plan. Instead of paying $600 or more for the best phone, simply pay the taxes up front and then a few bucks a month more on your monthly bill. Stop by your local Appalachian Wireless store or dealer today for more information. It's the better, simpler way to pay. And it's called the Appalachian Advantage because we are you. We are Appalachian Wireless.
Back here at Don McKenzie Field, and the regular season for Morgan County is over, Steve, and what a dramatic ending to this season. Morgan County falls to 1-9 to end the regular season, but nothing to be ashamed of here in the loss this evening.
No, it was a heartbreaking loss, but now I tell you what, they played their hearts out. They played a great game. It was a good way to finish the season.
Morgan County falls to 1-9 with the loss, and they'll go to Pike County to take on Shelby Valley next Friday evening at 7 o'clock to kick off the Class 2A state playoffs. Let's look at the final statistics, the unofficial statistics in this game. First, let's look at the scoring summary. Magoffin County and Morgan County both put 12 points on the scoreboard in the first period. In the second quarter, Magoffin County outscored Morgan County 14-8 and took a 26-20 lead to the locker room at halftime. Third quarter, Magoffin County outscored Morgan County 8-6, and they took a 34-26 lead into the fourth quarter. Morgan County outscored Magoffin County 8-6 in the fourth quarter and were stopped deep in Magoffin County territory driving to try to tie this game, and they fall to the Hornets. Final score 40-34. Scoring in this football game, let's look at it. In the first quarter, Magoffin County opened the scoring. Ian McCarty with a 20-yard touchdown run. The two-point conversion failed, and it was 6-0 Magoffin County. Morgan County answered. Joe Spencer with his first of three touchdown receptions on the night, an 18-yard pass from Bradley Nickel. The conversion failed, and it was 6-6 at that point. Magoffin County comes back with an Ian McCarty 11-yard touchdown run, and they took the lead at 12-6. Then Morgan County and Chance Wright closed out the scoring in the first period. Chance Wright with a 32-yard touchdown run, and we were all even at 12 going to the second quarter. Magoffin County with the first two scores in the second period. Ben Lafferty opened up the scoring with a 30-yard touchdown run, and it was 18-12, and Curtis Jenkins had the two-point conversion, and Magoffin County was up 20-12 at that point. Morgan County answered with a Joe Spencer touchdown reception again from Bradley Nickel, again 18 yards. The conversion by Chance Wright was good, and we were tied at 20. Magoffin County would score right before halftime. Curtis Jenkins with a 59-yard touchdown run, and the score at halftime was 26-20, Magoffin County. Third quarter, Curtis Jenkins again with a one-yard touchdown run for Magoffin County, 32-20 at that point, and then he had the two-point conversion as well, and it was 34-20. Magoffin County had their biggest lead of the night at that point. Guess who? Joe Spencer again. Touchdown reception number three for Morgan County. This time a 10-yard reception from Bradley Nickel. The two-point conversion failed, and we went to the fourth quarter with Magoffin County up 34-26. In the fourth quarter, Morgan County, Cameron Rogers with a 7-yard touchdown run. That cut the lead to 2 at 34-32. A big personal foul penalty after the touchdown on Morgan County backed the two-point conversion up to the 19-yard line. No problem for Cameron Rogers. He runs it in from 19 yards. The two-point conversion's good, and we were tied at 34. And then Curtis Jenkins, who else but Jenkins, a 10-yard touchdown run for Magoffin County, and that was the final score of the game, 40-34. Magoffin County had 18 first downs in the game, 45 rushes for 418 yards. Curtis Jenkins led Magoffin County, 20 rushes, 230 yards, and three touchdowns for Jenkins on the night. Ian McCarty, 15 carries, 125 yards, and two touchdowns. So 355 yards rushing between Jenkins and McCarty. Ben Lafferty, 8 carries, 74 yards. He had a touchdown as well for Magoffin County and the rushing attack. Dyson Burchett was 1 of 4 through the air for 46 yards, and Bryce Stanifer caught that pass for 46 yards for Magoffin County. Matthew Sparks punted the football three times for an average of 12.7 yards. His long was 40. Let's look at Morgan County. They had 21 first downs in this game, so they actually had three more first downs than Magoffin County. Morgan County ran the football 45 times for 323 yards. Chance Wright had 176 yards on 17 carries and a touchdown. Cameron Rogers also 17 carries, 127 yards and a touchdown. So, Steve, between these two teams, we had four runners with over 100 yards apiece and one, Curtis Jenkins, with 230 yards. What a night of running the football.
Yeah, it pretty much the running game did dominate both sides of the for the teams. And, I mean, you know, over 700 yards of running. And so unbelievable, both teams, and high scoring, high entertaining. But Morgan County, there's three scores on TD passes.
Well, so, Bradley Nickel was 5 of 12 through the air, yes, for 60 yep. yards, but three touchdown passes.
Yeah.
So, I mean, just you know, what a game.
Yep.
You just is, and you called it early in the second half, last team with the ball wins, and matter of fact, that's what happened.
That's exactly what happened. And but Joe Spencer, senior night, he came up with a great big night, three touchdowns, something he's going to remember for a long, long time.
So if you like offensive football, you had 847 yards of offense in this game tonight, and what a game to close out the regular season and to close out our 2022 telecast of Morgan County Cougars football. They will play next Friday evening in Pike County. They'll take on Shelby Valley in the opening round of the Class 2A state playoffs. We will not have that game. We'll not be back on the air with any sports here on MTTV for a few weeks, but we will be back with high school basketball, and that'll be coming up here within the next roughly 30 days, Steve.
Yeah, before you know it, it'll be basketball season. And, you know, we'll have a lot of games on the air, so everybody stay tuned, and we'll be there.
It's been a blast working the football season with you, Steve. I've really enjoyed it.
I have enjoyed this. It's been fun.
And, it's been fun.
And I tell you what, Chris, you do your homework, you're ready, you're prepared, and I tell you what, you're getting good with that iPad.
Well, I appreciate the kind words. We appreciate you all watching us wherever you've been across our viewing area all through this season. Elliott County, Morgan County, Menifee County, Wolf, and parts of Bath County. I'm Chris Dickerson. For Stephen Gullett, the rest of the MTTV Sports Television crew, we'll see you back here on Channel 2 for 16th Region Boys and Girls High School Basketball in just a few days. Have a good evening, everyone. Good night.